Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Roland DeVries, along with my broadcast partner, Derek Slayton. We are streaming live from Alumni Stadium at the campus of Delaware State University in Dover, Delaware. We're here to put a cap on the 2013 gridiron season. Delaware State closes out the season against longtime Mideastern Athletic Conference rival Morgan State Bears. The Hornets have won four of their last five games to improve to 5-5 overall and 5-2 in the MEAC. Delaware State University is coming off a 29-21 come-from-behind win over Florida A&M last Saturday. Morgan State, 4-7 and 4-3 in the MEAC, is trying to rebound from a 38-3 loss to South Carolina State in its last outing on November 14. Morgan State enters this contest as one of the MEAC's better rushing teams. The Bears are fourth in the league in rushing at 173.5 yards per game. This is the 57th meeting between the Hornets and the Bears, and is Delaware State's second oldest rivalry, behind 69 games at Howard. Delaware State won the last meeting, although Morgan State holds a 32-24 lead in the series. The last time the teams met, the Hornets posted a 28-23 victory over the Bears in Baltimore, Maryland in 2012. We come back, Byron Dixon will have our weather and his thoughts on today's matchup before he covers the rest of the game from the sidelines and the stands.
Will be at 48 degrees. It looks pretty windy out here with 12-mile-per-hour winds coming from the west, which will be something to look forward to in the kicking game and the special teams aspect. If you look behind me, the DSU Approaching Storm Marching Band is currently not here, and they are currently under investigation. Roland will tell you a little bit more back about that. Back to you, Roland.
Thanks, Byron. Yes, it was a little over a week ago that there were some allegations brought from some of the band members to higher authorities that there was some hazing going on within the band. An investigative team was formed, and they came up with enough evidence to show that indeed some hazing was taking place. And the administration has then set forth that they have suspended the band's operation throughout the rest of the fall semester. Well, given that the fall semester will end up here in the middle of December, it's expected that we're not going to see Delaware State University Approaching Storm Band until after the first of the year, which means that they will not be able to perform at the December commencement. Now I'm going to turn it over to Derek. Derek, the Hornets, after a brutal start, have rebounded quite nicely, and they have a chance at a MEAC championship.
Yeah, Delaware State is currently third in the MEAC standings. Bethune-Cookman and South Carolina State lead the league with 6-1 records. A Delaware State win today over Morgan State and losses by Bethune-Cookman and South Carolina State this weekend will create a three-way tie atop the conference standings at season's end. So this is just so we have a chance. We have a chance, and let's go to the keys of the game.
And they have rebounded quite nicely for this campaign. What are the keys to today's game, Derek?
Well, we got to stop the run versus Morgan State. They're number four in rush offense, like you said, 173 yards per game. Put eight people in a box. This is a team that does not throw the football very well, only completes about half of their passes, and they also have 10 interceptions on the season. For Delaware State's offense, they have to take shots down the field. Last year, former quarterback Nick Elko completed 17 straight passes at one point and threw for 398 yards and two touchdown passes. And finally, we have the winning turnover margin. We are 4-0, the Hornets are 4-0 when they force more turnovers than what the opponents have. So those are some three keys to win this game for today.
Thanks, Derek. Right now on the field, they are recognizing all the seniors that are playing their last football game today here at Alumni Stadium. And off in the distance, I see coming through the west end zone, Morgan State Marching Band is about ready to come onto the field. They were invited up here to provide entertainment for the halftime that we'll have. going to be delayed with a kickoff today due to the fact that they're recognizing all the seniors. There was a half a dozen of them that they have given the honor to, bringing the families out there right at the midfield strike.
When you talk about some of the seniors, but only about a half a dozen, this is a team that's going to bring back 9 starters on the offense, 8 on the defense. This is a team that was projected to finish 8th in the conference, but like we said, they have a chance to finish number 1 if they win today. But just to look at the future, of course they're going to lose Corey Murphy, and for the two times they're going to have to replace a quarterback, 3 different quarterbacks in 3 years. It's hard on any team. But they have 2 great receivers in Malik Golston and Milton Williams, and they have a good running game with Malcolm Williams. He'll be healthy, more healthy next season. And defensively, they are losing Ernest Ajay, but they're going to bring back a terrific secondary. Devon Moore will be coming back from his ACL injury. Tarik Colston is another good safety. So this is a team to look forward to be very competitive next year and for the years down the road.
It's going to be a tough game for him this today as well. The offensive line has just been ravaged with injuries. Darren Helwig's going to be sitting out this game today. And these young freshmen and sophomores have done a great job. They're going to lose their center. Brandon Cunningham graduates, so he's finishing up. But this young offensive line got a good year of experience underneath their belt. And so I'm looking forward. Of course, we have to still play today's game, but I think a lot of people are looking forward to next year's football team here at Delaware State.
Yeah, it's a lot to look forward to. I think we'll hear some more from Byron, but 6 home games. We had only 4 home games this season. 6 home games is huge compared to 4. And this is a team that was 3-1 on the road. So they were 3-1 against the MEAC teams on the road. And 2-1 at home. So they can win anywhere. But to have 6 home games, to have more balance where you don't have to go to the road once, you know, it seems like 2 times, 3 times a month is going to be much better. Or maybe once a month you have a road game, or 2 games in a month you have a road game. It's a big difference in terms of just traveling and having a chemistry with your team is great, but also it takes a lot of physical toll on you to get on a bus, travel 6-7 hours to a game, play the game, then get right back on a bus, have 10 to 15,000 fans booing you. It's much more of a difficult situation than to be on a road. I mean, be at home for 6 games.
And 2 of those road games are actually going to be pretty locally. We have University of Delaware. They'll play up in the Blue Hens. And then also they'll be playing Temple University at Lincoln Financial Field. So those are 2 nice close games that actually kind of make it like 8 little home games for this next season coming up.
The
teams are both off the field right now. Referees are starting to gather at the 50. Getting ready for the coin toss here coming up.
What do you predict the score will be for this game?
I said earlier I expected it to be a good scoring game of 28-7 for favor of Delaware State. I think they can pick apart this Morgan State defense, and with the offense the way it's been churning up points lately and gaining some good yards, I think they're going to put 28 points on the board.
I think Delaware State will win. Of course, we're biased, but I think Delaware State will win if they can get the passing game going early. This is a team that doesn't run the ball very well, so the short passing game will be huge. Some screens, some just easy completions where you get the ball out of Corey Murphy's hands quickly because, like you said earlier, they got a weak offensive line due to injury. Second worst in the MEAC in sacks allowed with 34. So they're going to have to get the ball out quickly. But also, they're going to have to take some shots down the field with Milton Williams and Malik Golston, 1 and 2 respectively in receiving catches in a MEAC. 100 receiving catches combined. I keep saying yards. So it's going to be an interesting game. I think it's going to be close. Delaware State cannot be afraid to take shots down the field because Nick Elko had almost 400 yards passing last game. And Tavis Tarpley, the former Delaware State receiver, former great, had 12 of those catches for 143 yards and a couple of touchdowns.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting match. I'm really hoping this offensive line can get through their injuries that they've had, give Corey Murphy the production to where he can open it up. I'd like to see good games besides just Malcolm Williams running the football, Najee Jackson has got to step it up, as well as Dae-Hun Chung. A good balanced attack of passing and rushing should prove to be very fruitful for today's matchup against the Morgan State Bears. The Bears have taken the field. They are situated in the east end zone. And we're still waiting for Delaware State to come on board. Who do you have for impact players of the day?
I think impact players for Corey Murphy is for the quarterback. Let me say they got to throw the ball a lot, so he's our impact player. First in the MEAC in passing yards. This is his final game as a Delaware State Hornet. Was one of the people that was announced for the senior day game. And defensively, it's going to be Ernest Ajay. This is a team that, and Morgan State that loves to run the football. Had four people with 300 or more yards on the ground. If they can stop the running game and force these guys to pass, they can force a lot of turnovers, and they can force a lot of three and outs and get the offense back on the field quickly, which can lead to a 28-7 score like you were talking about.
I'm hoping that defensive front, too, will cause some pressure on their quarterback, Robert Council, because lately the defensive front four has not given the pressure that Delaware State needs. Well, the team captains have met at midfield, about ready to do the coin toss right now. Morgan State has the option of calling the toss. Delaware State has won the toss, but has deferred to the second half. So Morgan State will receive the football. It will be moving left to right on your radio dial. We have today's officiating crew is meeting up there in the midfield right now. The referee today will be Fleming Williams. The umpire will be Derek Wells. The head linesman, Jason Soisman. The line judge is Trey Blake. The side judge is Tom Potts. The field judge is Lenny Golden. The back judge is Jeff Barber. The play clock is Roddy Byers. Game clock is Walt Calloway. The observer today is Jim Tucker. And the grader is Rusty Acree. A lot of excitement here at Alumni Stadium as Delaware State trying put a cap on this fine 2013 football season. So Mitchell Ward leads him out there. He's got the T set at the 35. Dropping back is Orlando Johnson.
Kicking off for Delaware State University, number 35, Mitchell Ward.
Orlando Johnson and Tubatain Taylor are back to receive the kick. Mitchell Ward puts the boot in it. It's going to come down to Tubatain Taylor. And he is going to run out of bounds for a touchback. Ooh, that was close to him stepping out at the one.
I thought he stepped out at the one. That's a good break there.
Oh, they're talking about it right now. They may have him stepping out at the one. Nope, they're going to bring the ball out to the 20. So it'll be first and 20 for the Morgan State Bears. That was dangerously close from stepping out at the one.
I really thought he had both feet in bounds when he caught it. I thought he stepped out at the 1-yard line.
So Seth Higgins, 6 foot four, 230-pound junior, will lead the Morgan State Bears out on the offensive front. First and 10 at the 25, ball is resting at the right hash.
And expect to see both quarterbacks, Robert Council and Seth Higgins, both of them are scrambling-type quarterbacks. They run the ball a lot, second and third, respectively, in running.
Goes left. He's got an open receiver at the 26. He's hit out of the bounds, 28-yard line. Nice catch by Antonio Jefferson. So it'll be second and 8. Ball sits at the 27-yard line.
It looks like they're getting their play calls from the sidelines, but they're trying to hurry up the pace here.
He's got two in the backfield. He's got Deontay Holland back there as well. Higgins gives to his back. No, he keeps it. Now he's coming around on the right side. He's brought down after a pickup of about 8. It's going to be first and 10 at the 35-yard line.
And expect a lot of running. These are dual-threat quarterbacks, but they're not really great passers like we talked about. Only complete about half of their passes. They're into just another extension of the running game. A lot of run options. So Delaware State will have to load the box to stop them.
Malcolm Banks checks in as the fullback. Higgins got two wide receivers to the left.
And once you get to see them go into a hurry-up, but then they get their play calls from the sideline.
He resets it. Now he gets a man in motion moving over to his right. Higgins gives it to Brown. Brown hit right at the line of scrimmage, but he broke the tackle, and he's up over the 41-yard line for a pickup of 6. It'll be 2nd and 4. Brown is a lone setback as he's got two wide receivers to the right.
Once
Higgins
again,
resets
get that.
Again, looking over to that sideline. Higgins on a keeper. He's over the 41. He's going to be a little short of the first down as he's brought down. It's going to be 3rd and less than a yard at the 44-yard line. Higgins on a design keeper just came around the right side. Right now, we're not getting any pressure or containment on that left end.
And the Bears are 5th in the MEAC in third down conversions, 36% on the season. Del State showing
Higgins rumblings. Keeps it on a sneak. He's going to have the first down. He's up over the 45-yard line, up to about the 46. That'll be Williams with the tackle. 1st and 10 at the 46.
And we talked about the offensive lineman, a 360-pounder, get right behind him. Clarence Swain, 360 pounds. This guy was bigger than everybody by at least 2 times in size when we looked at him.
He is a big man, Clarence Swain. Fake the broom. Higgins back to pass. He's got a man that's caught at the 40-yard line of Del State. He's finally brought down.
Looked like Joe Boyd was just a half step away. It looked like if he got there a little earlier, would have been able to get an interception on that play.
The ball stayed in the air a little bit long, and Joe Boyd just couldn't get over there to make the defensive play. So it'll be 1st and 10 inside the Delaware State 40. Higgins in the shotgun. He's got Brown in the backfield. And Adam Miller has checked in for the first time. He fakes to Brown. He keeps it, and he's going to be caught in the backfield and brought down for a 5-yard loss. Great play by Willie Bolden, who stayed at home at the defensive back position and just met him 5 yards deep.
I've been impressed all season long about the secondary because they don't just cover. They also come up and make great running tackles in a running game. They tackle very well in space, and that was just another good example.
Loss of 5, it'll bring up 2nd and 15. Higgins in the shotgun. He's still got Brown in the backfield with him. 3 wide receivers to the right and 1 to the left. A drops back, looking down the middle. He stumbles. Now he's going to run with it. Hit by AJ. Still on his feet. He's going to get the ball down to about the 32. Nice pickup after a nice scramble. It'll be third and two. Ball is being placed at the Delaware State 37-yard line.
And these aren't your traditional fragile quarterbacks. He's 6'5", 230 pounds. And you could just see all the strength on display breaking through arm tackles. You got to tackle these guys like they're running backs.
So far, Morgan State has been able to move the ball quite successfully against this Delaware State Hornet defense. Higgins up under center now. Gives it over to Brown. He is hit right at the line of scrimmage, and he did not pick up the first down.
It's like Rodney Gunter was the first person in meeting. Good job getting some penetration and stopping a run game on that one.
Lamont Brown was hit right at the line of scrimmage. It's going to be fourth and the same. Maybe it'll be even lost a yard. It's going to be about fourth and three. Ball is spotted at the left hash, marked at the 37-yard line. They are going to go for it. Two wide receivers to the right for Higgins. Now Deontay Holland sets up on the right side. Here comes Higgins again. He's going to pitch to Brown, who's got an opening, and he will score. Lamont Brown is going to go untouched into the end zone. Morgan State. Well, Seth Higgins read the defensive end, pitched it to Brown, and he just scampered around the right end untouched there.
This is a team that runs the ball. I think had about 480 attempts entering this game. You got to stop the run. You got to load the box. But you have to play disciplined football and have it contained. You just can't run at Seth Higgins because they have other options who can. They have four people who run for 300 or more yards so far this season.
Well, the extra point was good as Chris Muller, the redshirt freshman, booted it through. Morgan State has a lead of 7-0 with 9:29 left in the first quarter. Delaware State about ready to get the football for the first time this afternoon.
It would be very important for Corey Murphy and company to establish a long drive of their own. Delaware State Hornets defense looked a little tired out there towards the end. This is a team that runs no huddle in Morgan State, and they could tire you out with their physical running game.
Well, the Bears chewed up 5.5 minutes on the clock, passed only one time, and the rest of the time they were running the football and made a nice sustained drive. Well, Milton Williams and Malik Golson are going to drop back inside their 10 to receive this kick.
Muller
gets his team lined up at the 35-yard line.
We haven't seen Air Scott in a couple of weeks. I think the last game we covered is the game he got hurt. He had the wind knocked out of him at first, but it was a very hard spill on his back. Could probably still be for that injury that he's not back there returning kicks.
Well, Muller puts the boot into it, and we got a flag right on. It looks like it's going to be offsides against Morgan State. Milton Williams picks it up at the 24-yard line, and he's hit and dropped at the 28-yard line. But we got a flag. It's sitting here on the near sideline on the 32-yard line. Morgan State may have jumped the gun. Waiting for the official word on it. As Fleming Williams is talking it over with a couple of his. A 5-yard penalty, it's a legal formation, is one of the Morgan State Bears were not within the 5-yard increment needed for the lineup. So they'll just tack on an extra 5 yards. So it'll be first and 10 for Delaware State at their own 33-yard line. We'll be starting off in the left hash. Corey Murphy's going to drop back with four receivers to his right and one to the left. He's going to flare it out. He's got Malcolm Williams at the 30. Williams hit at the 34, and that's where he's going to be. His forward progress is going to stop for a pickup of about one.
Good job with the read of the screen. You could kind of see that was the play that was developing because Malcolm Williams was out there and was behind all three receivers. You kind of expected a screen on that play.
So it'll be second and eight. Ball now spotted on the right hash with two wide receivers to the left and two to the right. Corey Murphy drops back. He's got a man, and that is Bo Cerevolo, and he's got the ball, and he is out of bounds right at the first down marker. We'll see where they actually spot it. They're actually moving the chains, so it's going to be first and 10, the Delaware State 43-yard line, pickup of eight.
Bo Cerevolo was one of the big-time players in their comeback win last week against Florida State A&M.
Corey Murphy gives it out to Dae-Han Chung, who picks up about 2 yards. He's going to be brought down around the 45-yard line. Brought down there by Christopher Robinson, middle linebacker. Second and eight, pick up a two. Chung stays in the backfield with two wide receivers to the left, two to the right. Corey Murphy in the shotgun, drops back. He's looking, he flares it out to Chung in the left flat. He's got blockers and he's up over the 50. And finally brought down inside Morgan State territory at the 44-yard line. Pickup of about 12.
And a good drive so far. They're using the short passing game to supplement their running game, getting the ball out of Corey Murphy's hands quick. This is a team with a lot of injuries on that offensive front. They got to get that ball out quickly.
And that they did. Corey Murphy read it quite nicely, and Dae-Han Chung picked up two good blocks, one from Milton Williams and the other one from Malik Golson. So first and 10 at the 44. Low snap. Murphy digs it up. He's looking deep. He's got Milton Williams, and he overthrew him. He had Milton Williams breaking open deep at around the 10-yard line, but just floated harmlessly in the midfield.
I think he panicked a little bit with the low snap and kind of hurried his throw. He had him. Looked like one of the corners slipped for Morgan State. That's a good break for the Bears.
That would have been six. Dae-Han Chung, lone setback. Three wide receivers to the right. Milton Williams to the left. Malik Golson's in the slot along. And that's who he's after. Malik Golson's got it, hit at the 40, and dragged out of bounds at about the 39-yard line on the Delaware State sideline. Check that. It's out of bounds at the 40. So that bring up third and seven.
And I really like the play calling right now. Easy throws. Really just easy reads. Get Corey Murphy comfortable. Get him in some rhythm. This is a team that threw for 400 yards against the Bears last time they met.
Takes a lot of pressure off the offensive line, too. Xavier Jones is getting a start at right guard. Murphy waits on the snap. They're coming with a blitz. They got pressure. He gets it up in the air, and it's intercepted at the 30-yard line. Tipped by Malik Golson. Fell right into the hands of their linebacker, Bill Hill. And so the Delaware State Hornets, another turnover bites them, Derek.
And it seems like it's always within that 30-yard line, like we talked about. In between the 30s seem to be where they turn the ball over a lot. And just another situation where they did not see the blitz in time. And Corey Murphy rushed a throw, probably should have never been thrown.
Yeah, it was a poor throw. And Malik Golson, of course, he's just trying to do the best he can by bringing a ball and tipped it up. And the old tilt drill went right into Bill Hill's hands. So it'll be first and 10 for the Morgan State Bears. Ball is marked at their own 35-yard line with 6 minutes and 52 seconds left in the first quarter.
On the bright side, they did get a few first downs, and that defense got some rest on the sidelines. But you would have loved to finish with some points, not an interception, of course.
Well, Seth Higgins is up under center. Now what do we have here? We have a timeout by Morgan State. That'll be their first charge timeout.
Looked a little confused on the offensive front, and a timeout had to be taken to keep the delay of game penalty from being called.
Well, Delaware State's trying to recover from this early turnover here, already trailing 7-0. With again 6 minutes and 52 seconds left in the first quarter. So far, Seth Higgins has been able to do whatever he wants to offensively for the Morgan State Bears.
But this is a heavy run team. They have to stop it. They have to make Morgan State one-dimensional, make Seth Higgins or Robert Council or whoever they put back there to beat you down the field in the passing game.
Well, Herb Walker Jr. is going to step in for the first time there at the tailback position for the Bears. He is the lone setback. Coming in motion is Ladarius Spearman. They give it up over the right side. He's going to have a first down as Herb Walker just broke it for 12 yards off the right end.
And he showed a little bit of explosiveness and shiftiness on his first carry.
5'8", 180-pound freshman, so he's not that big. And he's definitely, you can tell the height contrast with him standing next to Seth Higgins back there. So Walker Jr. still remains his own setback.
The Hornets showing
blitz. Three wide receivers to the left. Higgins in the shotgun. They're giving it off to Walker again. He breaks it along the right side and another nice pickup. If he's got another 12 yards as he brings it into Delaware State territory and down at the 45-yard line.
And I don't understand why the Hornets didn't load the box on these couple of plays. This is a team that's not going to pass the football on you, especially first and 10, second and 5. Those are running downs for them. The safeties are playing a little too far back.
And the end is getting hooked. I mean, he is unable to contain that right side, and they're just coming around it. And we're breaking free for 10, 12 yards a crack. So Walker Jr. in the backfield. Here comes Antonio Jefferson in motion. They give it to Walker right up the middle, and he is hit in the backfield. And he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The Hornets have done a good job when the runs have gone up the middle, but like you said, when they run to that right side, it seems there's just a whole bunch of green in front of them, and they're able to get 10 to 15 yards of carry on that side.
Rodney Gunner and Willie Bolden with the tackle right there. It's going to be 2nd and 10.
Nice, and the Hornets bringing some people up.
Here comes Higgins on the option, pitches it off to Walker. Walker's loose off the left side, and he's going to be brought down after a pickup of about 8. He is shoved out of bounds at about the 35-yard line. It's going to be 3rd and 2 from the 37, so a key 3rd down here for the Delaware State defense.
Last time the Hornets were unable to get a stop here. Morgan State threatening to score again.
Higgins again checks off, looking over the sideline for the play. Now he's up under center. He's going to give it to Walker. Walker right back up the middle. He's going to be close to the first down. He may be a little short. Rodney Gunner brought him down right there at the marker. Appears to be short. It's going to be 4th and less than a yard at the 35-yard line of Delaware State.
Last time they went with a quarterback sneak.
And they again do it, but we have a flag on the play. We got a legal procedure.
And that's huge because it looked like he had it. It looked like he was going to get that first down. So a huge penalty. It looks like they're going to bring the punt unit out.
That they are. So a false start does the Morgan State Bears in. As Lawrence Forbes is about ready to kick it away, Malik Golson is back at his 10-yard line to retrieve it, and still no Aris Scott. Punt is off. Malik calls for the fair catch. It bounces at the 10 and goes out of bounds on the Delaware State sideline. So it'll be first and 10 for the Delaware State Hornets.
Good job by the Hornets forcing a punt after the turnover on the Hornets' offensive first possession.
First and 10 for the Hornets. Ball at 10-yard line. 3 minutes and 52 seconds left here in the first quarter. Malcolm Williams sets up in the backfield behind Corey Murphy with two wide receivers to the left and right. They give it to Malcolm Williams, coming right up the middle, and he's got about 4 yards before he is brought down at the 14-yard line.
I remember early in the season when we interviewed Malcolm Williams, and we told him that this team was ranked to finish eighth, projected to finish eighth. His expression when he saw that was priceless. He couldn't believe it. I don't think he was told that they were supposed to finish eighth. I don't think anybody on this Hornets knew, as they have a chance to be number one with a win and some help today.
Murphy flares it out to Malcolm Williams. He picks up good blocks out there, up over the 20 and down 25. It's going to be first and 10 for the Hornets at their own 25-yard line. Great blocks over there by Bo Saravolo and Milton Williams.
And a short passing game has been very effective, except for the one tip that led to the interception. When Corey Murphy gets time, he's as good as any quarterback in the MEAC.
It's good to see Malcolm Williams getting some running room out there, whether it be on the ground itself or on those short passes. They give it to Malcolm again, right up the middle.
No, it looks like Murphy
picks
kept
up
it.
About two. Yes, he did. Murphy's had a bad habit of fooling me on these plays. What a great fake. They got me again.
Yeah, and if Murphy didn't slip a little bit, he would have had a lot more yards. Had the whole defense fooled, had us fooled. We heard the Morgan State coordinators on the other side yelling, you know, he has the football. Everybody was a little lost on that play.
So the pickup of about 3, 2nd and 7. Murphy sits in the shotgun. He drops pass. He's got Milton Williams on a slant move, and Williams makes a nice catch and run, and he's finally brought down at the 44-yard line.
Anytime they see one-on-one coverage on Milton Williams, they're going to go to him. 6'3", 6'4", a guy who had a lot of D1 offers until his injury his senior year, has tremendous talent.
2 minutes, 13 seconds left here in the first quarter. Corey Murphy leading this drive down the field. Sits in the shotgun. He gives it off to Malcolm Williams, who's got some nice running room for a pickup of about 4 yards. And he's brought down there at the 47-yard line of Delaware State. Second and 5, so it's good to see some nice 4 or 5-yard runs that they're getting here early on.
And this is a depleted offensive line, but the easiest thing to do is just to tell them run forward and just knock somebody off the line. That's what they're doing so far.
Dae-Hun Chung gives Malcolm Williams a breather back there, and they give it to Chung. I take that back. He comes to Murphy again on that fake. Ooh, he went down awkwardly.
Went down
right
awkward
there at around the 46-yard line. Slow getting up. He kind of slipped and got hit at the same time, and it didn't look good on those knees, but he is up. First down. Well, Corey Murphy picked up the first down and moved the ball into Morgan State territory, and the Hornets are in Morgan State territory for the second time this afternoon, but they have nothing to show for it with less than a minute to play and a clock ticking here in the first quarter. First and 10 at the 46-yard line. Corey Murphy in the shotgun swings it out to Dae-Hun Chung, who's got it, and he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, he did a good job making one player miss, because that looked like he was going to lose about at least 4 yards on the play.
Cody Acker just blew that one up there in the backfield. Weak side linebacker came in and making a nice open field tackle on Dae-Hun Chung.
I would like to see the Hornets take a shot here. Even though they are playing safeties back, they're moving up the second the ball is hiked. They're not expecting anything deep down the field.
Second and 10, Murphy again. He's looking left. Over to the right, he's got Malik Golson. Picks up about 3. It's going to be third and 7 at the 43-yard line of Morgan State.
It's like Chase Phillips with the pressure. Really didn't have anything there. Everybody was covered up pretty well.
Cody Acker's helmet came off, so. Stoppage in play. The end of the first quarter.
At the end of the first quarter, Delaware State trails Morgan State University 7-0. As many of you may know, Delaware State University starting quarterback Corey Murphy is a senior. This is actually his last collegiate game. We actually had a chance to catch up with him before the game. He said it was bittersweet, this being his last game, and he wants to go out with a win. He wants the Delaware State University to finish first, but he knows that they may not finish first. He's from California and hopes after graduation that he's able to come back and help his team as well. And as far as what's next for him, he plans to play anywhere he can, whether that be CFL, arena football, or NFL. With that being said, we'll send it back to you guys.
Thanks, Byron. Yeah, Corey Murphy's had a great career here at Delaware State, and he's putting on a fine 2013 campaign. It's going to be hard to replace him next year, Derek.
Yeah, and I think that's one of the only issues the Hornets have to face, that and losing Ajay on as a linebacker on the defensive side. But they are bringing back a lot of starters, 15, I think.
So, Corey Murphy set with a 3rd and 7. He drops back. He's looking left. He's got right over the top of Morris Frazier. He had him open. He fired the ball high. It went right through his hands. And
lucky it wasn't picked off, too.
Oh, my. Close again. He had him open. He's got to make that catch. And he's got to make that throw. So, Dell State will have to punt. Marco Cano will come in. Try to pin the Bears inside their 20. And Marco Cano over. It's going to be tough losing this guy as well. Roderick Gager steps back to take it.
And we got a flag. Going to get a rough in the kicker.
The ball bounces at the 5, and it's going to be run right out of bounds at the 4-yard line. So another great punt by Cano.
I expect this to be Hornets football. Cano took a big hit, and the flag is out.
It is, resting at the Delaware State 46-yard line. So roughing the kicker caused a 15-yard penalty on Terry Harris, Jr. of the Morgan State Bears. So the Hornets are back in business. They get the football, and they're going to march it off 15 yards and place it inside the 35. It's going to rest at the 33-yard line and see if the Delaware State Hornets can capitalize on this possession.
In Corey Murphy's mind, you got to think no turnovers. We got at least a chance for a field goal here, so no reason to be overly aggressive.
Milton Williams goes in motion off to the right. Now he's going to reverse field. And they throw it back the other way to Bo Saravolo, who's got it at the 25-yard line. He's tackled inside the 20 down to about the 19.
Nice play design. You see that a lot in the NFL. They fake it one way, set the screen up on a weak side, and they normally get a lot of yards. Arrington Jones III, one of a former NFL player in his own right, so he knows all about that type of play.
Well, they spotted on the far hash at the 20-yard line, pick up about 8, so it'll be 2nd and 2. Malcolm Williams is alone, set back behind Corey Murphy, who has 2 wide receivers both ways. They give it to Malcolm Williams. He's going to have the first down as he makes it up over the 20 down to the 16-yard line.
And I like the play call that Arrington Jones is using. Different formations, lots of runs, lots of passes. They've gotten this offense into a good rhythm. Now they just need to put some points on the board.
So, 13 minutes and 50 seconds left here in the first half. First and 10 at the 16. Murphy drops back. He's got a man at Saravolo again at the 10. He's brought down inside of it at about the 8-yard line.
And Saravolo in the last couple games have emerged as that third target that they've needed to take the pressure off of Golston and Williams in the slot, or even when he's out wide, does a good job running those short to intermediate routes.
He's second and two from the 9-yard line. The Hornets are trying to capitalize on this penalty on Morgan State. Tries to put some points on the board and tie this ball game up.
And the Bears showing pressure.
Murphy up under center. Malcolm Williams, the lone setback on this second and two. They give it to Malcolm Williams over the right side, and he is brought down at the 1-yard line. What a great run by Malcolm Williams. It's going to be first and goal inside the one. Looked like Malcolm Williams was going to get in there for just a minute. And they grabbed him and brought him down right inside the 1-yard line. So it'll be first and goal on the right hash. Malcolm Williams, a lone setback, and Corey Murphy's going to get up under center.
Normally you would see Najee Jackson out here, but maybe they're trying to give Malcolm Williams the touchdown after a nice run.
They give it to Malcolm Williams, and he scores! Touchdown, Hornets!
Good job taking. I'm laughing a little bit because it seemed like the PA announcer just threw your catchphrase there. I forgot what I was about to say. I started laughing.
They've been spying on us.
But good job taking advantage of the penalty, the mistake on the rough and the kicker, and marching down the field. Nice mixture of runs and passes. And now hopefully it'll be 7-7 after the point after.
Well, we've had our fair share of trouble on the kicking game here, all of it coming from the snap itself. So let's see if Kano can get this one down. He gets a good snap,
and it's blocked.
Mitchell Ward drove it right into the interior line. It was blocked.
I think Joe Rankin, the defensive back who came on the corner, might have got a hand on it. Seemed like he tipped it first. And they've just struggled with that all season long. And I think nothing more than that Norfolk game we covered just a couple games ago.
The kicking woes continue for the Delaware State Hornets. With 12 minutes and 26 seconds left here in the first half, it is Morgan State Bears 7, Delaware State University Hornets 6. Recently, DSU received a top honor when it was named by the Association of Public and Land Grant Universities as the 1890 Land Grant University of the Year. DSU received the honor because of its overall performance in the APLU's 14 award categories. DSU was in the top three of nine categories, including first in research, of which it also received the APLU's research award. Well, Mitchell Ward getting ready to kick the ball away to the Morgan State Bears. There's Orlando Johnson and Tubbatane Taylor dropped back to receive it. Ward's grounds it into the ball. Tubbatane Taylor's got it at the 15. He's coming right up the middle with it. He's outside the 35 and brought it out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
And that's something me and you both don't like is when they do the squib kicks. They seem to give up so many yards. I just don't understand it.
I don't grasp that concept either. Here they're starting off now at the 42-yard line. They're almost at midfield, and they didn't even have to work for it.
And we've seen Mitchell Ward in the past kick it out of the end zone. He has enough strength. The squib kicks, he either seems like it's going back for a touchdown or they're getting at least 30, 40 yards on each time they return it.
Seth Higgins. Holland off to his right. Deontay Holland. Now Higgins getting some pressure. He breaks free to his right, throws the ball out of bounds past the 50-yard line. His intended target there was Nate Ingram. He was well covered there on the play.
And we have the Morgan State coordinators in the other booth, and we could just hear them screaming as it seemed like so much confusion was going on in that play.
Yeah, we could hear them screaming that Holland was on the wrong side. And Brown was not where he needed to be as well, so. We got Holland and Brown both in the backfield behind Seth Higgins.
opponent
Dell
showing
State's
pressure.
State's got to form some pressure on him. Higgins tries the option. He pitches off to Brown. Gets hit at the 42, but is able to dive over the 45-yard line. So it'll bring up a third and long, make it six.
And they're moving the football back, looks like to the 45 where his knee hit. Well, like his knee hit first before he was able to stretch out for the extra 3 yards.
Key third down for the Hornet defense here. Seth Higgins brings back the shotgun. He's got three wide receivers to the left, one to the right, and Lamont Brown is his lone setback back there.
Hornet's looking to rush about five.
Higgins gets it, dropped back. He's looking to his right. He's getting some pressure. Now he's going to run. He stumbles. The ball is on the ground. And it was picked up there.
It looked like his knee hit.
Did they call him down?
Yeah, it looked like his knee hit.
They are calling him down. The head linesman is marking him down at the 48-yard line. That'll bring up fourth and three.
That's a good break for Morgan State.
So a key hold there for the Delaware State Hornets as they're going to see if they can get the football back here on this punting situation.
And it all starts by stopping the running game on the early downs. Then we saw some confusion in the passing game on Morgan State's hand where they just had nobody open.
Lawrence Forbes off with it at his 35-yard line. They get another flag on a roughing a punter as the ball is going to go into the end zone. As like Kevin Jocelyn ran into the kicker, either way, whether it's a 5 or 15, they're going to get the first down. Well, he's going to get an earful from the coach for something of that nature.
And it didn't even seem like it was necessary. It didn't seem like he was getting close to blocking a punt. He got it off with a lot of time before he even met him. You got to be more composed out there. So the Hornets, being the courteous people they are, decide to give them a roughing the passer. A roughing the kicker as well. And now Morgan State has a chance to take advantage and put some points on the board.
So Morgan State retains possession. They're going to start off inside of the Delaware State 37-yard line. First and 10, Higgins back there. He's got Lamont Brown behind him. Higgins up under center. He gives it to Brown. Brown breaks up over the 45, or into the 45, down to the 33-yard line. It's going to be second and about seven.
It seems like each time someone moves in motion, that's the place where they're running to. That time it was Thomas Martin, the receiver, moving in motion, and then they run to the strong side.
Dell State runs a similar type of offense sometimes with three wide receivers to one side and one to the other in a single setback. Brown again back there as Higgins looks over to the sideline to get his play.
But what makes both offenses unique is one team is running off of it and another team is looking to throw more screens off of that type of formation.
Higgins is running. We got flags on the play on both sides. He's hit at the 30 and down inside the 28-yard line. It's Corey Scott came up to make the tackle, but there's flags. Probably a legal formation.
Seemed like every single ref that had a flag decided to throw it on that one.
Came from the side judge and the line judge, so it's normally something on the line formations.
Yeah, both teams are pointing at each other saying, no, he jumped off sides. No, he was false start. Let's see what the call will be.
Well, two fouls on the play. They had a legal formation that they declined, and then they have the holding penalty on Kareem Barton, which they're going to accept for 10 yards. So that'll set the Bears back to the 43-yard line of Delaware State. So it'll be second and 16 from the 43-yard line. Higgins drops back, again looking over to the sideline. Odd, all the receivers look on over. Lamont Brown is the lone setback sitting off to the left. Higgins drops back. He's got some pressure. Now he's got Brown in a middle screen up over the 40, the 35, down inside the 30-yard line, and he is going to be brought down at the 28-yard line. What a pickup for Lamont Brown on that screen pass.
And it was a good play because you saw the secondary of the Hornets, all of them dropped back near the first down line, so they just dropped the screen underneath and had some blockers. He was able to get a lot of good yards out of that.
It's going to be bring up a third and short, 1 yard for the Bears. They bring in their big package into it as Deontay Holland, the fullback, sets off to the right. He's not hard to spot with those big orange sleeves on.
Once again, they're in motion.
Holland over to the left. They give it to Brown. Breaks a tackle at the 28, and he's going to be brought down at 25 as Joe Boyd finally got him down to the ground. But it's going to be a first down for the Bears inside the Delaware State 25-yard line.
And once again, they run to the motion side. This time it's the fullback, motions to the left, and that's where the running back goes, right behind number 45 on the fullback for the first down.
So first and 10, Delaware State 24-yard line. Holland remains in the back or disregard. Lamont Brown is the lone setback as Higgins gets up under center. They give it to Brown. He's running right up over the 20, inside the 20, and down to about the 16-yard line. It's going to be a pickup of about 7 yards.
And it looks like, is that Ernest Ajay that's down on the field?
Tough to tell right here. Yes, it does. It is. It's Ernest Ajay on the field. Ajay is down at around the 16-yard line on the Delaware State sidelines. He's rolled over to his back. Now they're helping him up. He's up on his feet. He's going to get some help off the field.
And Ajay, one of the seniors, this is his last game. Hopefully it's nothing serious and he gets to finish out his collegiate career.
That's a tough loss for the Hornets defense.
Looked like a lower body injury.
He was limping just a little bit coming off there.
And also Antonio Jefferson is limping off for the Morgan State Bears. He's the second leading receiver for the Bears.
Well, it's second and two. Ball sits at the Delaware State 16. It's 7 minutes and 40 seconds of counting here in the first half. And right now, the Hornets just don't have anything to answer against Seth Higgins, Morgan State Bears.
Maybe that's
except
the answer.
Except that, met in the backfield, Rodney Gunner grabbed a hold of Lamont Brown and dropped him.
I think they found an answer right there. They just, it seemed like everybody knew it was a run play on that play. They had to be in some, I don't know how they got there so quick.
He lost about 2 yards on there, so it would be third and four. Ball sitting at the 18-yard line. So a key third down conversion here for the Delaware State Hornets. Higgins keeps that big package in. Now he's going to run right. He pitches off to Brown. He's got room. Up over the 15. We have a flag coming in late as he's finally brought down at about the 10-yard line. The Hornets are pointing towards the Bears.
And a good open field tackle, too. Could that look like a touchdown?
Tubbatane Taylor with the holding. And that negates a first down there for the Morgan State Bears.
And a couple of holding penalties is just killing their drive right now. That's the second one for this possession.
Holding penalties have done in the Morgan State Bears and personal foul on both teams.
Watch out for the screen on the right side. They have three receivers lined up there. Normally when you get a trip set, one of the receivers will drop back for a screen.
See what Higgins does. He's got Lamont Brown in the backfield with him. He drops back. He's looking right. He's got Harrison flanked to the left. Oh, but he's got a wide open receiver. Did he come down with the ball in bounds? They are saying no catch. He was bobbling. What a excellent effort out there by Thomas Martin, but he had great coverage and just couldn't keep it in bounds.
Like Cameron Judge got there just in time to knock him out of bounds. And this is a pretty good secondary.
Fourth down, and they've sent the field goal unit out there. Chris Muller's going to line up for a 44-yard field goal from the left hash.
And I don't think that was Cameron Judge's man. He broke off his man and just played the ball and was able to knock him out of bounds.
It's a good thing that ball hung up in the air a little bit. So Muller up with it. Ball is up. And it is good. A 44-yard field goal for Chris Muller as the Morgan State Bears now lead Delaware State University Hornets 10-6 with 6 minutes and 18 seconds left in the first half.
That's a victory for the defense because of the roughing the kicker. Gave them great field position to hold them to a field goal. It's something you got to applaud the defense for doing.
So, Del State about ready to receive the ball again. DSU is establishing a DSU Early College High School on campus that is scheduled to open in the fall of 2014. It will be designed specifically to serve first-generation college-bound students and will have a great emphasis on science, technology, engineering, and mathematics curriculum. Students will also be able to earn a maximum of 60 hours of college credits while finishing high school. The last two of a series of parent and student information nights for those interested in the early college high school will be held at 6 p.m. on December 3 and December 17th in the DSU Living and Learning Commons. Del State set to receive the football with Milton Williams and Malik Golson at their goal line. Looks like it's going to be Golson at the 5. He's coming out with it. Picks up a nice play at Murray Williams. He's up over the 20, up over the 25. He's finally run out of bounds on the Delaware State sideline. At the 25, so a nice run back of 16.
It's important for the Hornets here to, I know they're going to look for points, but to at least run off 3 to 3 minutes and 30 seconds off this clock. So if the Morgan State Bears do get it, they won't be able to go with their traditional run offense.
Corey Murphy sits with 3 wide receivers to the right. They give it to the up back. That was Lamar Shaw getting his first carry of the day. He picks up about 3, maybe 4. It's going to be 2nd and 6 from the 28-yard line. Shaw stays into the game. Corey Murphy has 2 wide receivers to the left and 2 to the right. They give it, fake to Shaw. Murphy's going to run with it off to the right side. He picks up a nice gain. It's going to be short of the first down, about 2 yards.
And he made a good decision not to pitch it to Malik Golson on the outside. There was nothing there. He cut it up the field and got 5 on a carry.
So, it'd be 3rd and a manageable 3 at the Delaware State 32-yard line. Murphy drops back. He's got Robert King, who's hit right as he catches it. It's going to be close to the first down marker. We'll see if they give it. Yes, they did. 1st and 10 for the Delaware State Hornets. Wow. Nice catch.
Looked like a generous spot. I think he was a little short than that. But that's the spot he's given for the first down.
He was hit, ball bobbled, and he still hung on to it and got the first down.
That was a tough catch.
Ball sits on the left hash. 1st and 10 for the Delaware State Hornets at their own 35-yard line. Murphy faced a chung. Now he's got Malik Golson in the flat. He is hit at the 36-yard line and driven back. Maybe a pickup of about 1. Be 2nd and 9 with 4.5 minutes left here in the first half.
And they've ran, I think, 1 too many screens on that play. Morgan State was prepared and put a good hit on Golson. Like to see them attack a little bit more vertically down the field.
That slant route has been open throughout the whole season. They may want to check on something like that with Milt Williams coming across the middle.
Maybe a deep post down the field. Safety's playing a little high.
Well, Corey Murphy swings it out to Bo Cerevolo, and he can't hang on to it. as he was open again, and Saravolo just dropped the football there at the 44-yard line.
And it's a couple of – each time it's a low snap, it seems like Corey Murphy hurries just a little bit. Going to have to get a, give him a little bit of a better snap than that so he can keep his head up the field.
This is a key third down conversion. You really don't want to give that football back up over to the Morgan State Bears with a little less than 4 minutes left here in the first half.
Or at least a completion that get the clock running, keep the clock running, even if it's not for a first down.
Third and long for the Hornets. Murphy drops back another low snap. Now whistles blow. See what we have. We have a timeout in Delaware State Hornets.
And those low snaps are becoming an issue. All it takes is one to just bounce away from him, and you got a catastrophe on your hands. You got to get the snap a little higher. It seems like he's rushing it.
It tends that Murphy is bending over constantly to pick up this ball coming in from his center.
And normally a quarterback gets two and a half seconds to throw the football. He's spending about almost 1 second just getting the football and looking up the field. He's taking a little bit too much time.
Well, Mangoni is he's a freshman, so he's young. Learning the trade there.
And for people just turning in, the game is 10-6. Both teams scored a touchdown. Unfortunately for Delaware State, they missed a point after that was blocked. And also on the last possession for Morgan State, they got a field goal after roughing the punter, led to a 15-yard penalty.
As we said earlier, the kicking woes continue for the Hornets. So Murphy back from the timeout. He's dropped back. He's got a good snap there. Now he swings it out to Dae-Hung Chung. Chung's going to be short of the first down by about 3 yards, but he gets it up over the 40-yard line, brought down at the 41-yard line. So that'll bring the punt team out for the Hornets.
And it takes at least some of the time off the clock. Makes Morgan State into more of a passing team if they want to go and score some points here. Marco Cano is a great punter, so expect him to be pinned back at the 15 to 10-yard line if he doesn't have a chance for a return.
Roderick Gager stands at his own 15 as Cano gets a punt away. It's a nice punt. He's going to bounce at the 20, inside the 20, and out of bounds at the 13-yard line. So a nice punt by Marco Cano. Pins the Morgan State Bears in their 13. They have 87 yards to drive to get that ball into the end zone for the Bears. But so far, Delaware State has really had some difficulty putting the pressure on Higgins.
Well, for the most part, it's just been a lot of runs. So they can't really run right after Higgins because they got to worry about the option on either side.
Well, there's a new quarterback checking in. That's Ricky Fisk. Fisk runs that ball, and he is going to be short of the 12, so he has lost about 2 yards. It's going to be second and 12 from the 11-yard line.
And a good job of pursuit and keeping containment. He was not even close of getting around the edge there to make any type of positive gain on that first down play.
Well, Higgins is back into the lineup now. He's got Herb Walker Jr. as his running back and Deontay Holland as the fullback. Higgins gives it to Holland. He's hit at the 13 and dropped down. Nice open field tackle by Corey Barnes. With 2 minutes and 10 seconds left here in the first half, Delaware State has called their second timeout. With a key third and long coming up for Morgan State, so Del State's trying to get this football back and maybe put some points on the board before the half ends.
I would be surprised to see if Morgan State puts this ball in the air. This is not a good passing team. Run the football and force Del State to call their final timeout is what I think they would go out here and do on his third down. Hornets can get the stop here, they'll probably be able to get the ball back in good field position, maybe the 40, maybe even the 50-yard line. So this is crucial, especially if they want to get some points here late in the first half.
They bring Herb Walker Jr. as their lone running back, and Seth Higgins is in the shotgun formation with three wide receivers to the right and one to the left. Now they're looking off to their sideline again, reconfirm their plays. Higgins dropped back, now he's going to run. He's got pressure. He's going to be... He's still on his feet and up over the 20-yard line. It's just some poor tackling and containment there by the Hornets.
I still think he's a little short, though.
Not sure. They're still looking to see where they mount, but it's fourth down, it appears. That it is. So they were able to hold, but not the finest defensive stand there by the Hornets on that third down there, Derek.
But the key thing is they got off the field. And also, Morgan State ran out of, it looked like Seth Higgins ran out of bounds. Actually, no, the clock is still ticking. I thought he ran out of bounds. Actually, now the clock stopped.
Yeah, it went from 152 down to 148, so maybe.
Now it's running again. Okay, they're confusing us.
Now it stopped again with 143, so they're really having some clock issues right now. And sure enough, the referee and the side judge are now going to get together and probably reset this clock. Inside of 5 minutes, that clock should never have started with Higgins going out of bounds. 147. But we saw it at 152, Derek.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure how they get to 147. The Hornets still lost 5 seconds off that clock.
But they still have a timeout, and they don't have a long way to go, probably the 40, maybe the 50-yard line to travel, unless they get a great punt here.
Malik Golson fading back to his 35, and he's going to get hit, and he's down.
And he ran back about 5 yards.
Great punt there by Lawrence Forbes, but better coverage there by the Morgan State Bears as Malik Golson caught it at the 35, and he was dropped at the 33. So it'll be first and 10 for the Hornets with a minute and 33 seconds left and one timeout here in the first half.
Still plenty of time to look down the middle of the field. They don't have to throw everything to the sidelines. And, of course, each first down and time stops until the ball is set. So they have plenty of time to move down the field. This is a passing team anyway.
So first and 10 at their own 32. Corey Murphy drops back. He looked right. Now he throws left, that swing pass. He's got Milton Williams. He breaks a couple of tackles, gets the ball up over the 45. Clock will stop on the first down as they move the chains. Delaware State moving in a hurry-up offense. He picked up 12. Clock continues to run with a minute 18. Murphy drops back. He's got time. He's got a man. And it is dropped by Robert King, who was wide open at the 25, and there was no one around him. It would have been 6 points. And he just dropped the football,
Derek. I have no idea how he dropped that one. He couldn't ask for a better pass. I think he was expecting that he was going to get hit, because when he caught it, he looked around and then just dropped it.
Unbelievable. Nice pass by Corey Murphy.
See, they can't get frustrated here. They are getting open down the field. You just got to keep taking your shots.
So, second and 10, he throws it again right out to Milton Williams, who stays on his feet, gets the first down, and he's out of bounds, stops the clock. What good presence of mind there by Milton Williams as he brings it into Morgan State territory, and he's down at the 43-yard line, 43-yard line of Morgan State.
Milton Williams is just a tough receiver to bring down. It's going to take more than just an arm tackle to bring him down. It's a form tackle. He's 6'3", 220 pounds. You got to find a way to bring him down.
So the Hornets move the chains. Ooh, they fake the pass, and they give it to Malcolm Williams right up the gut, and he's going to pick up about 6. So it'll bring up a 2nd and 4, and the ball inside the Morgan State 40.
And I like that play because you know they're going to bring pressure. Able to sneak in 6-7 yards on that carry.
So the ball sits at the 37-yard line of Morgan State. Clock continues to run with 40 seconds left. Corey Murphy drops back. He's going to fake down the field. He's got some time, and he's got Milton Williams coming back to the football at the 22-yard line. He picks up a first down. He had plenty of time to make his throw on that one there, Derek.
And a nice job by Milton Williams coming back to the football and adjusting to his quarterback scrambling and getting open.
Well, Malik Golson stayed out there in a flat form on the left side, but he saw Milton Williams downfield a little bit further and got the first down. Now Corey Murphy drops back. He's got time, throws over the middle. What a nice catch by Bo Cerevolo at the 6-yard line. So it's going to be first and 10 at the 6 looks for like Delaware State with 16 seconds left.
Corey Murphy signaling for a spike.
Clock continues to run. He's going to spike the football, it appears, and he does. So with 13 seconds left, Delaware State will still have a couple of shots at the end zone here to try to convert.
And Corey Murphy did a great job because they never had to use their timeout. So they can even run it one time if they feel they can get into the end zone. Or even if they get tackled, they could call a timeout and get a field goal unit out to kick a field goal and make it 10-9. But I would like to see them open up this kind of hurry-up offense a little more. The passing game was perfect.
And Corey Murphy's getting the protection that he needs to make these passes down there. The players are, getting open.
And making some diving catches, too.
Another in the drop by Robert King. Murphy's drag. He's got a man over the middle. Oh, what a great defensive play there by Paul Eatman. See Bronk over to break up a nice pass to Malik Golson in the end zone. So a little 8 seconds left. It'll be third down at the 6. So Delaware State still has one more shot at the end zone, trying to get the conversion of the touch. Corey Murphy up under center. He's looking. Oh, he threw it behind Milton Williams.
There was contact, but that football was uncatchable for Milton Williams, so they're not going to throw the flag out.
Well, burned a second off the clock, so with 5 seconds left, and I don't see a kicking team coming out here to attempt a field goal. Here it comes now. So
they've had their issues already. A point after was blocked. They've had some high snaps in the past. The Howard game we covered a couple weeks ago, high snaps led to missed field goals.
Well, Mitchell Ward, Marco Cano sets up at the 13, so it's going to be a 23-yard attempt from the right hash. This is huge to get this, and it's blocked again. Right up the middle it comes, and they block the field goal and fail
it looked like it was
to convert any points on this drive.
Looked like Joe Rankin again
came off
the
edge. As time runs out here in the first half.
He's coming free. Nobody's touching him. He just timing it right and just continues to make a play. Joe Rankin just two times now. He's the player of the game right now.
And the kicking woes continue here for the Delaware State University Hornets. Well, we're at the end of the first half here with the visiting Morgan State University Bears 10 and the Delaware State University Hornets 6. And we'll be right back. What else are we doing at half?
I already knew that I was going to go to college, you know, from a young age. I definitely want to major in political science. After that, I'm going to get my law degree. Then I'm going to come back to Detroit, boost the economy, become the mayor or something, try to make the situation better for other people. I feel like I owe it to the city. I'm determined. It's going to happen. My name is Justin, and I am your dividend.
For those dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community with experts and other caregivers to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
Here at the GED Pep Talk Center, we have Pep Talkers standing by to get you motivated for your GED diploma. Text the name Terry to 69222 for a sympathetic pep talk.
You show people what you really are.
Or for a gentle pep talk, text the name Deborah.
You know you're going to make people very proud of you.
And if that's not enough, text the name Danny for an extreme pep talk.
Prove everyone wrong. Show them you're the boss.
Get your GED pep talk and find free GED classes. Text the name of the person you want a pep talk from to 69222.
Ladies and gentlemen, he hails from Eastern Shore, Maryland. His major is music. He stands at 6'1" tall. Concluding his first year as a Machine Field Commander, Delaware State University, make some noise to introduce to you, drum major, Jody Brandon Jones. That young ladies are about to demonstrate is skill, class, and technique. Dance into a number by Bruno Mars. Make some noise for the Murphy State University Fosse Dancers! Ladies, please show everyone that when it comes to the art of dancing, while the Foxy Dancers, the best in the business. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise once again for the Foxy Dancers! Everybody get up! Everybody get up! Hey, hey, hey! We got any Robin Thicke fans in the house tonight? Delaware State University. Let me hear you. Machine, hit it! Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a moment to say thank you for the opportunity to provide you with some live entertainment during your halftime show this afternoon. We bring you greetings from the great city of Baltimore, Maryland. And to you, Delaware State University, we say hello. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your attention to the center of the field. They are the heartbeat of the machine. Make some noise for the University Hit Squad! Ladies and gentlemen, there is no percussion section in the world better than the Hit Squad. All right, Hit Squad, it's time to get funky with it. Let's go. Turn it up a little bit, Hit Squad. Together once again for the Morgan City Hit Squad! Dell State, do we have any fans of John Legend out here today? If so, sing along with the machine as they play one of his most popular songs of 2013. That song is Tonight. All right, Dell State, let me hear you. Ladies and gentlemen, attending an historically black institution is not just about advancing an academic career. It also involves forming lifelong relationships and creating new memories that will last a lifetime. So on the last game of the season, Delaware State University, remember the lessons learned, remember the friendships formed, and most of all, remember the sound of the Morgan State University magnificent marching machine. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together once again for the Morgan State University Magnificent Marching Machine. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment that you've all been waiting for. It's what takes us from high to higher. It's what separates a show-style marching band from any other band in the world. Dance into a master mix of songs by Ace Hood, 2 Chainz, and Kennedy Jones. Machine! It's time to party! Delaware State University, we thank you once again for allowing us to come here this evening to showcase what it is that we do. We hope that you have enjoyed the show thus far, because we have certainly enjoyed performing for you. Over the last few minutes, we've shown you how we march, how we sound, and some very beautiful women. And now, Machine, show them how we dance! Machine, let's get to work. Go! Machine, catch your breath, and let's get back to work. We got any 2 Chainz fans out there today? Machine, let's go! Morgan on the beat. Machine, give yourselves a room and let's get back to work. And what you do? Machine, it's time for us to wrap it up. But before we do, now let the beat drop. Ladies and gentlemen, remember this day in history, because today was the day you experienced the world's most captivating and entertaining band live. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Mr. Melvin and Miles Jr., Director of Bands and his staff, we want to thank you once again for allowing us to entertain you during your halftime show. You all have been a great audience. Join the Machine in the Carl J. Murphy Fine Arts Center on Saturday, December 7th at 4 p.m. for the annual marching band show. Tickets are available at Ticketmaster.com and Ticketmaster charge by the phone. To find out more information about the Machine, visit us online at the web at MSUBand.org, or follow us on Twitter at MSUBand. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise once again for the Morgan State University Magnificent Marching Machine.
Recently, DSU received a top honor when it was named by the Association of Public Land Grant Universities as the 1890 Land Grant University of the Year. DSU received the honor because of its overall performance in the APLU's 14th award categories. DSU was in the top three of nine categories, including first in research, of which it also received the APLU's Research Award. DSU is establishing a DSU Early College High School on campus that is scheduled to open in the fall of 2014. It will be designed specifically to serve the first-generation college-bound students and will have a great emphasis on science, technology, engineering, mathematic curriculum. Students will also be able to earn a maximum of 60 hours of college credits while finishing high school. The last two of a series of parent-student information nights for those interested in the early college high school will be held at 6 p.m. on December 3rd and December 17th in the DSU Living and Learning Commons, the former Sheraton Hotel just north of campus on DuPont Highway. The Delaware State University Choir will present its Christmas season concert, Gloria, under the direction of Dr. Lloyd Mallory Jr. at 4 p.m. Sunday, December 8th, in the Education and Humanities Theater.
We are back here at Alumni Stadium. Delaware State trails Morgan 10-6. Delaware State will receive the second half kickoff. As you've seen in the first half and stated before the game, the win has had an effect on the kicking game. It has been a blocked extra point and a blocked field goal to end the half. If you consider with those two makes, the game would actually be tied. Hopefully, Delaware State University can drive down the field and put some points on the board. They have been a strong second half team this season. And hopefully, they can continue that with the last game of the season. That being said, I'll send it back to you, Roland. Thank you.
Thanks, Byron. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're about ready to start this second half here at Alumni Stadium, Delaware State University in Dover, Delaware. Been about a little over a minute before kickoff here, and we're trying to bring you up some scores from other MEAC conferences, but we're having a little difficulty bringing that type of data in, so may not have any scores for you. Derek, what's Delaware State have to do here for the second half, Derek?
Well, their special teams need to be better. That's one thing that we know. This would be a 10-10 game, but two block field goals, one of a point after, and then a field goal just before halftime, before halftime expired, was blocked as well. I think they're doing a good job stopping the run as of late, and that's one of the keys against is to stop the run. But once again, they're losing the turnover margin, a turnover in the red near the red zone on our first possession. Took away some points. Could have possibly been a touchdown. You never know. And that led to a field goal on the other side for Morgan State. So they got to take care of the football. And also the penalty with the roughing the kicker was another huge one. So they're playing good football. They just need to take care of the ball and not commit bad penalties. And if they can do that, they should be able to pull off the victory.
Well, that last offensive drive right before halftime that ended with a blocked field goal, Delaware State really opened it up. They went with a hurry-up offense, and they were making some great receptions, marching the football down the field, and they just ended up with not getting any points to show for it.
I would like for them to open up the offense like that a little more pace. It seemed to throw off Morgan State, even though they knew the passing was coming, they could not stop these receivers one-on-one on the outside. So I would like to see them up the tempo and throw the football around.
Well, they put the foot into it. It's going to be covered by an up man at the 25. He's up over the 26 and brought down there. So it'll be first and 10 for the Delaware State Hornets. They're on 26 as Brandon Lewis, a linebacker, was the one that actually fielded that kick. It's going to be rare that he ever touches the football on a kickoff.
Yeah, and you can see it because he grabbed it right away from another Hornet like, no, this is mine. This is the opportunity
I've
been waiting
for. This may be
the
only time I ever catch the ball. First and 10 for the Hornets at their own 27-yard line. As Corey Murphy sits back there with Malcolm Williams in the backfield. They give it to Williams. He breaks it up. Check that. That's Dae-Hung Chung over the 30 and down at about the 33-yard line. Pick up of about 8 or 6. It'll be second and 4.
Dae-Hung Chung has really been their most consistent on the ground.
and he's going to check out of the game as Malcolm Williams checks in for him. Corey Murphy sits with three wide receivers to the right and one to the left. Malcolm Williams, a lone setback. They give it to Williams, and he's up over the 35-yard line and down at the 38. He's going to have enough for a first down.
Good start for the Hornets on the ground. Two carries for a first down. Whatever they can do to get those two safeties to come in closer to give Milton Williams and Golson a shot on the outside.
First and 10 for the Hornets. Ball sits at the 38-yard line of the Hornets on the left hash.
Now they're showing some pressure.
And here they come with it. Murphy's got time, throws it down the field, and it's almost intercepted as Joe Rankin went high for the football but just couldn't bring it back down at the corner position.
And I just don't understand. He just threw that football up there. Corey Murphy, just get rid of the football, but don't just throw it in the middle of the field. That's a poor decision by their senior. And they also got to pick up that blitz better. It didn't seem like he knew where they were coming from. As a quarterback or the center, those two need to communicate and get the offensive line to pick up where the pressure's coming from.
So second and 10 at the 38. Empty backfield for Murphy in the shotgun.
Yeah, showing pressure up the middle.
And here they come with it. And they get the ball out to Phil Saravola, who makes a nice catch at the 41. So he picks up a few yards. It's going to bring up a manageable third and about six at the 41.
And they're bringing two linebackers. One comes immediately, then they do a delay, and it's a delay blitzer that's getting close to Murphy and forcing him to rush these passes out.
Yeah, that was Bill Hill that was bringing the pressure up the middle. Here he comes again. Murphy's got pressure. He dekes the pressure. Now he's got a man down the field, and it's Robert King.
He's got
the 35, the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Hornets! A 41-yard touchdown strike by Corey Murphy to Robert King.
And that was a great play by Corey Murphy just to avoid the pressure, but then to throw it, had the presence of mind to throw it down the field. And Robert King was one of the persons who dropped a key catch that could have been a touchdown earlier, makes up for it with a tremendous grab in traffic, and takes it 41 yards to the house. Huge play by the Hornets, and look like it's a swinging game formation is coming out.
Well, here we go with the dreaded kick. Mitchell Ward is going to try to convert this extra point. We're going to see if we can get a football go through these uprights.
Looks like they're having some type of trickery coming on, but now it seems like they're going to line up.
So, with a minute 59 expired in the third, Delaware State now leads 12-10 with the extra point pending. High snap, they get it down, it's up, and the kick is good as Mitchell Ward finally gets a football through the uprights this afternoon.
Finally, he has somebody block the outside edge. It normally was Joe Rankin, but he wasn't out there, so they had no pressure on a kicker this time, and he just shows him what you can do if he doesn't have pressure in his face. Good job by the special teams making that adjustment.
So with 13 minutes and 1 second left here in the third quarter, Delaware State takes the lead for the very first time today as they now lead Morgan State University Bears 13-10. That catch by Robert King over the middle, it looked like a couple of defenders collided and they fell down, and Robert King was just able to just sprint for the end zone. And what a nice catch after an earlier drop over the middle before the first half ended. It's good to see him recover.
We talked about it earlier in the game. The last time these two met, the Hornets threw for almost 400 yards down the field. There's some opportunities there. They just have to take advantage of it. Early, Milton Williams was missed down the field, and then Robert King dropped one, but he held on to this one. And now the Hornets have the lead.
So Orlando Johnson and Tubitane Taylor dropped back to receive the kick. They're standing at their own 5-yard line. Mitchell Ward about ready to put the foot to it.
Let's see if he kicks it deep or if they still go with the squib kick here.
See what he does. He's going to kick it deep, and it's going to sail deep, and it's going to be out of the end zone. So it'll be first and 10th, the 25-yard line for the Morgan State Bears.
And it's something we've talked about. He can kick the ball out of the end zone. He might as well do that every time. Last time they went with the squib kick, they returned it for 41 yards and put their defense in a bad position.
Now the Bears have to go 75 yards, which is a lot better than giving them the field all the way up to around a 40 or 45 and make their distance to the end zone a lot shorter. So Higgins brings his team out for the first time here in the second half. He's got the setback, and that's Brown. He gives it to him, and he's hit at the 25 and down at the 26. Pickup of about one.
A good thing about the Hornets defense, since we've been covering them, it seems each time they come out of half with a better adjustment on the defensive side, and whenever it is, they seem to just do a better job stopping the run in the second half. Also, Ernest Ajayi is back out there. We've seen him leave early in the first half due to a lower leg injury, but he's out there. He's one of the seniors for this Delaware State Hornet team.
So Higgins drops into a shotgun with Lamont Brown off to his left. Two wide receivers. They fake it to Brown. He's got time. He's looking off to his left. Got the ball out there, and it was dropped.
Looked like the receiver was just kind of impatient with that pass. It hung up for about 5 seconds, it seemed like, but he still should have brought that one in.
Tubbitane Taylor was wide open at the 40-yard line. He just dropped the ball as it bounced off there in his chest. So this is a critical third down for Delaware State, trying to hold the Bears and get the ball back.
You know, Hornets have a very opportunistic secondary in the last few weeks. Ronald Robertson, Joe Boyd, Tarek Colston, all of them have the ability to force some turnovers of interceptions or even force fumbles.
But again, Seth Higgins is just having time back here. We've seen this week after week where the quarterback is just having all day to make his throws, and he does again, has a completion at the 40-yard line to Graylin Harrison, which is enough for a first down. It's going to be first and 10 at the Morgan State 40.
Dominique Woods, the offensive lineman for the Bears, is limping back to the line of scrimmage. Didn't see what happened there, but maybe you want to bring some pressure to that side.
Yeah, Higgins has had all day. He can drop back there and he can survey his grounds and pick out the receiver he wants. He's going to fake the pass, and now he's going to run it right up the middle. He's hit at the 47-yard line, dropped at the 49. Pickup of about 9. They'll bring up second and 1.
Have not seen Robert Council yet, the actual starting quarterback. I don't know if it's injuries, but we talked to their head coach, and we were supposed to see both of them. Have not seen Robert Council.
No, Ricky Fisk is the only other quarterback we've seen for the Morgan State Bears this afternoon.
And that was one play, limited action, a run to the outside that got no yards.
So Higgins in the shotgun again. He's going to roll to his right. Now he's going to try up the middle. He's hit at the 48, and that's where he's going to be stopped for no gain. Maybe even lost about a yard. So it's going to be third and a short 2 at the 48-yard line. Of Morgan State. The Hornets got to come up with a key stop here. They bring Deontay Holland, the fullback, in. Big package offense.
They've run off of this formation a lot. I wouldn't be shocked, though, to see them go with play action or something. Normally they've run on the side of the fullback.
And that's what they're going to do. They pitch the ball out to Lamont Brown, and he is going to come up short of that first down as he has run out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Good read by the Hornets as they force the issue there.
Good job on the outside as well by Willie Bolden. He was the first to meet Lamont Brown and kind of get him out of bounds. Very good job right there reading the option. Even me and you up here at the top, when we're no football scouts, can understand where they're just running wherever the fullback goes to.
Bring on fourth and 2, and bring out the punt team. So a key stop here for the Hornets as Malik Golson drops back to his own 20. And Lawrence Ford
and the Hornets
standing
coming from
as 33. He gets the punt off. It's a beauty. Golson calling for the fair catch, and he makes that catch at the 16-yard line.
Last possession, they hooked up with Robert King for a 41-yard touchdown pass. I think they should still kind of look down the field, especially deep down the middle. They've had some opportunities in the middle of the field on some couple of seam routes.
So a 36-yard punt for Forbes. puts the ball on the 16-yard line of the Hornets on the right hash. Hornets are moving right to left on your radio dial.
Let's see if they adjusted to the pressure. They were getting to Corey Murphy and forcing him to scramble out the pocket with some delayed blitzes and through the middle.
Well, Corey Murphy is up under center. He fakes it to Dahan Chong, and he's throwing deep to Milton Williams, and it's over Milton Williams' head. And a good breakup there by Deshaun Summers at the 50 as he overshot Milton Williams.
It seemed like Isaiah Lewis was the one who brought a hit on Corey Murphy, forcing him to rush that pass a little early. They had one-on-one on the outside what they wanted, but Corey Murphy's going to need a little bit more time back there.
So, Dahan Chung remains in the backfield with Corey Murphy. Murphy is in the shotgun with three wide receivers to the right and Milton Williams to the left. He drops back, swings it out to Chung, makes a cut at the 15. He's up over the and down at the 19-yard line. Going to be a pickup of about three. It's going to be bring up third and seven for the Hornets. Empty backfield now for Corey Murphy.
I feel like they're going to the empty backfield too many times and it's allowing them to get some pressure.
And they're going to bring six and they throw it over the middle and Milton Williams got mugged at the 30. The ball falls incomplete there and Delaware State's going to have to punt the ball.
I think Malik Olsen thought that pass was for him. He reached up and probably made it a little harder for Milton Williams to catch the football there, but also good coverage.
It was a pretty unproductive series there for Delaware State. Now they're going to have to punt the ball over to the Bears as Broderick Gager stands at his own 38-yard line to get the punt from
one
Marco
thing that's
Cano.
Good about the special teams is Marco Cano. Very, very good punter.
And he gets off a wobbly one. Gager comes up with it, drops the football, but he recovers it at his own 42-yard line. Check back, Gager didn't come up with it. Peterson, John Vier picked it up.
And that was big because he was kicked right in the middle of the field with a short kick. Probably had some room to return if he was able to field that. He already has one touchdown on the season, Gager does. A big break by the Hornets that he was not able to catch that cleanly.
So Higgins goes under center for the one time. They put the ball on the ground and the Hornets have got it. L.B. Williams with the fumble recovery inside the Morgan State 40-yard line. They land on the ball at the 38. What a big turnover there for the Hornets.
And just looked like the exchange was bad. Maybe the running back thought the quarterback was going to keep it for a run, but he just missed the handoff.
Huge turn of events here at Alumni Stadium as now the Hornets have it with 8 minutes and 54 seconds left here in the third quarter. It's first and 10 at their own 38-yard line.
I would like to see the Hornets run the ball. The pressure is getting to Corey Murphy right now.
Najee Jackson checks in for the first time. He's looking down the middle, and he throws it right into the hands of Joe Rankin, who's coming the other way. Now he's going backwards. And Milton Williams finally makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. So an ill-advised throw by Corey Murphy as Milton Williams didn't even see the ball.
I think Corey Murphy thought Milton Williams was going to break on the inside. Milton Williams kept going down the field and never saw the football. And he had some time. They did a good job picking up the blitz. But just miscommunication on that play. They just squandered a possession with a turnover there. That's the second interception of the game for Corey Murphy, 14th on the season, in his final game as a Delaware State Hornet.
Another turn of events here at Alumni Stadium. It's now Higgins has the ball, first and 10 at his own 33. Drops back, fakes to Brown. He's got time, looking off to his left. He's got a man, but he's out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
And that's just a poor throw right there.
Graylin Harrison was wide open.
And he put a great move on a corner and just had himself all day. But Seth Higgins kind of just lofts it up there out of bounds. and misses a huge opportunity for the Bears.
Second and 10 from their 33. Ball is marked at the right hash.
And I'm surprised they're throwing a football this much on early downs. They're just not a good passing team. I know you want to keep the defense off, you know, balanced a little bit.
Well, they got the big back in there. Deontay Holland is back there along with Lamont Brown. Let's see what they do with the football. Higgins drops back. We got another flag, and he's trying to run it. He's got a little bit of room, and now he's up over the 35, and he should be brought down at the 39-yard line. Pickup of about 8, but there is a flag on the play, so we probably have something on the offense. We'll see.
And Morgan State's getting a little predictable. Once again, Hollins come in, and a run to the side of Hollins. But it's like a offsides.
Offsides on number 48, LB Williams.
Each time Hollins is in, they just run to that side.
So, they'll take the run off the board and take the 5-yard penalty, which will bring it 2nd and 5 at the 38-yard line.
And Hollins is in once again on the right side of Higgins.
Higgins gives it to Brown, who's going to go right up the middle. He's up over the 45 and down at the 47-yard line. Pickup of about 8. It's going to be 1st and 10
now
for the Morgan State
Bears.
That's
more like Morgan State to run on a first down. A tough run by Lamont Brown up the middle.
1st and 10 from the 46-yard line of Morgan State with 7 minutes and 53 seconds left on their third quarter here. Delaware State leads this football game 13-10. Higgins drops back. He's throwing to his left. He's got a man, and that is Thomas Martin. He's brought down inside the Delaware State territory at the 47-yard line.
They don't really have a big-time passing game, but when they're looking to make some completions down the field, Thomas Martin leads his team in receptions, 26 receptions entering today. He's their go-to receiver. Once again, looking to the sideline for their play call.
2nd and 3, Lamont Brown in the backfield. Deontay Holland split way off to the far left. Higgins is going to run right, and he is hit in the backfield, but he still picks up a couple of yards. He's going to be short of the first down, brought down at about the 45-yard line of the Hornets. 3rd and about 1.
Morgan State's gotten a lot of 3rd downs and 1s, 3rd down and 2, but have really struggled converting on these short yards possessions here, which is weird because they're such a good running team. You would think a 3rd and 1 would be a piece of cake for them.
Higgins is going to call timeout. He just didn't like the lineup of what the Hornets had out there. The Delaware State University Choirs will present its Christmas season concert, Gloria, under the direction of Dr. Lloyd Mallory, Jr. at 4 p.m. Sunday, December 8th, in the Education and Humanities Theater. Tickets are $10 and can be purchased on the DSU website at www.desu.edu/holiday concert. We are looking forward to our second annual December commencement on December 14th in the Memorial Hall Gymnasium, where the keynote speaker will be Kent Amos, a DSU alumnus from the class of 1970. A former Xerox executive and currently a nationally renowned educator in Washington, D.C. charter school founder. Mr. Amos will share a lot of wisdom on what it means to succeed and how that should also include service. Well, teams are back out there as Higgins looking at this 3rd and 1. We got Holland and Brown in the backfield. Higgins is going to fake to Brown. Now he's running straight up the middle, breaks a tackle inside the 40 and down at about the 37-yard line.
And we got the Hornet down, getting up a kind of slow
pickup of about 9.
like Corey Scott was a little banged up, but he's back up on the field.
So the ball is sitting on the left hash. Evens with Holland and Brown in the backfield. They fake to Brown. He drops back. He's got time, and he's going to throw it off into the right or left flat. That was off the fingertips of Ladarius Spearman. Good coverage out there by the Hornets.
The one thing I don't like about Morgan State in their passing game, they're running only one or two receivers. And on that play, one of their receivers slipped up, so he had nowhere else to go with the football except to the outside on the left.
And Higgins balls don't tend to get out there quick. They hang out in the air for quite a while to where the Hornets played a little bit more tighter on defense. They could have some interceptions here. So Holland and Brown in the backfield, and that tandem has been out there for the majority of the game. Higgins drops back. Now he's going to run it right up the middle. He breaks a tackle at the 35. He's up over the 30. Inside the 25, still on his feet, inside the 20. Breaking tackle, still finally brought down inside the 15-yard line.
The football is out, but I think they're going to rule him down.
They're saying the ball is down, even though the Hornets came out of there with it. But that was just some poor tackling there by the Delaware State
Hornets.
Yeah,
it seemed
like
for the last 15 yards, they were trying to rip the ball out of his hands, but they weren't bringing him down. Normally, you'll have one player hold the quarterback while they go for the strip. They just went straight for the strip, and the quarterback kept moving his legs and picked up a lot of extra yards.
So the Morgan State Bears are inside the red zone. They have it at right hash, the 15-yard line. First and 10. Lamont Brown's the lone setback. Ball's on the ground. Whistle blows. Let's see what we have here. I think we have a timeout here. Morgan State burns their second timeout here in the third quarter with 5 minutes and 9 seconds left. And Delaware State leading the football game 13-10. Right now, Derek, the Hornets don't have an answer for Seth Higgins running the football. What do they got to do?
I think it's just got to be disciplined and expect to run. A lot of times he's faking like he's about to pass. They run past him, and he just runs up the middle. You got to be thinking, stop the run first, even if he has the ball in his hands.
Well, there's two broken tackles by Lamont Brown in behind the line of scrimmage, and he gets up over the 10, right at the 5-yard line to where he picks up 10 yards. It's going to be first and goal at the 5-yard line. Just poor tackling there by the Hornets. First and goal at the 5. Ball sits on the right hash. Lamont Brown is a lone setback. Two wide receivers to the right. Double tight end formation. Higgins up on their center. He gives it off to Brown, who's going right up the middle. He's hit at the 4 and down at the 3. So a pickup of 3 will bring up second and goal from the 2. Now they bring Deontay Holland in. Both wide receivers drop out. And we see Malcolm Banks check in as a second fullback. So a huge package offense for the Morgan State Bears here, as Banks checks in for the very first time this afternoon. Deontay Holland splits off to the right. Banks is right behind him. They give it to Brown, and Brown's going to follow them both right into the end zone. Untouched for Morgan State Bear touchdown. So with 4 minutes left here in the third quarter, Morgan State gets on the board again. Makes it 16-13 with the extra point pending by Chris Muller.
And Morgan State really just playing smash mouth football in that possession. The passing game really wasn't working. They just kept going with the run. Seth Higgins made a couple of big time runs on that play.
And Muller converts the extra point to now make it Morgan State 17, the Delaware State Hornets 13. They just don't have an answer for Higgins. Either when he's when he drops back to pass, they're not putting any pressure on him, and when he runs out in the open field, he's normally not getting hit until he gets 5 yards under his belt.
It doesn't bother me that they're not getting too much pressure on him passes, because he's throwing incomplete passes. They're not getting beat by the pass. But running the ball, he's just making good decisions. They're falling for the fake on a pitch, and he just keeps running up the middle. He's really just a running back disguised as a quarterback. He's not going to beat you with his arm. He's going to look to beat you with his legs the majority of the time, and that's what he's done so far.
But I think as a defense, you really want to put him on the turf a few times just to make him think a little bit differently when he decides to run the football. But when he's not getting pressure, he's not getting hit, he's just free to roam whatever he wants to do. Well, Malik Golson and Milton Williams back there at their own 10-yard line waiting to receive this kick by Chris Muller. Muller's a big kicker, 5'11", 235 pounds. Gets the ball up. It's going to be taken by Milton Williams at the 20. He's up over the 25, still on his feet, and he's finally brought down at the 28-yard line. So a return of about 8 yards, and Delaware State will have it first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Just a good job by Milton Williams holding on to the football. When he started stumbling, some of the defenders were trying to poke the football loose. Good job just holding on to it.
Muller kicked it high and short, and it hung up there for quite a while. Longerson was just waiting for Milton Williams to be able to catch the football. Well, Malcolm Williams is the lone setback with Corey Murphy. They give it to Malik Golson on reverse, and it fools no one. As Cody Acker got in the backfield and dropped him for a loss.
Yeah, he leads their team in tackles. He's 14th in the MEAC. He's a linebacker that just knows how to play the game of football. Read that play perfectly. And Malik Golson's not the biggest guy, was unable to get free of the arm tackle.
So that's a loss of 5. It's going to bring up a loss of 6, 2nd and 16 from their own 22-yard line. This is not the direction that the Hornets wanted to go. So Golson goes in motion now. Now he comes back the other way. Murphy drops back, throws it low and short to Malik Golson. And right now, the Hornets just look sluggish on offense this third
and
second half.
Corey Murphy looks hurried in the pocket. Didn't really have too much pressure. Did have somebody coming up to him, and he just kind of got rid of the football quick.
3rd and 16. So far, the Hornets just cannot get anything going here in the third quarter. There's 3 minutes and 8 seconds left. They trail 17-13 to Morgan State.
They're showing pressure.
And here it comes off the left side. Murphy dances a little bit. He's got a man, threw a high to Milton Williams again. His high throws have been high, they've been short, they're just not as crisp as we're used to.
He's just hurried in a pocket. He doesn't have enough time. His offensive lineman, Corey Murphy's been sacked 34 times this season, so you know he's already has quick feet thinking of, you know, what do I got to do really quickly, and he's just hurrying himself a little too much. When he made the first lineman miss, he should have reset his feet and he would have been able to complete that pass.
Another unproductive series for the Hornets as they lost 6 yards in that whole possession. Another high snap to Kano. Good thing he's tall. He gets off a wobbly kick coming up to make the catch. Fields it at the 40. Still on his feet at the 45, and finally somebody gets Broderick Gager down.
Looks like that was Kevin Jocelyn, who was guilty of the roughing the punter early in the first half.
Well, Kermit Blunt's defense is going to have to rise to the occasion again. So they're going to have to stop them. They've spent the majority of this half on the field.
Yeah, it was unfortunate that they couldn't get a more productive drive out of Corey Murphy and the Hornets on offense. They're going to have to find a way to stop this run option offense of the Morgan State Bears. And it all starts with just knocking Seth Higgins on the ground.
And they haven't been able to do that. Deontay Holland goes in motion. Now he sets up, and here comes Higgins right behind, off the 45, cross midfield, inside to the Delaware State 46-yard line. Pickup of about 9. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 1.
And what makes it hard to stop them is they're lining 3-4 receivers up, so they can't really put 7-8 guys in a box unless you want to just play man-to-man coverage one-on-one against these receivers, which I don't think the Hornets want to do.
Check that. He picked up 8, not 9 yards. So it'll be 2nd and 2 from the Delaware State 46-yard line. Here comes Higgins again. Now off the right side. He's across the 45, inside the 40. A flag comes flying in as he's finally dropped down at the 38-yard line. He was brought down there by KJ and Ernest Ajay. So we have a holding call that kind of stops the bleeding a little bit. Back them up 10 yards, and it'll bring up 2nd and 12.
This is a big possession on 2nd down to stop the run and make them pass on a 3rd and long.
Check that. That was a spot foul, so that'll bring up 2nd and 9. The Morgan State 47-yard line.
They've gone with some misdirections on a run with Seth Higgins. Well, he'll line up and look like he's going right or left and just go the opposite way. He's done a good job with it. It's full of defense.
Herb Walker was now they get some pressure and they get him down. At the 30-yard line, they finally put Seth Higgins onto the ground.
And this L.B. Williams just came free, and Seth Higgins never knew. He never knew that he came free. Pump faked on a pass and just got drilled.
He did get hammered, and it's a wonder Higgins didn't see him.
That makes it 3rd and 23. It's not a lot of plays that you can call to pick up this amount of yards.
Well, we called it that we needed to get pressure on Seth Higgins, and we finally got it on that play right here. So Higgins sits back there in the shotgun, 3 wide receivers to the left, and he's going to give it to his running back. That's Walker. Herb Walker Jr. picks up about 6-7 yards.
And Tarek Colston
put well a short of the
big
first
hit on him. Tarek Colston, a safety who was playing corner, but due to Devon Moore's injury, moved to free safety, just came up and made a good tackle. Him and Bolden did.
And Bolden looks a little shook up. We can see him off there. He's getting some attendance. He's dropping the right shoulder a little bit.
But a good job by the defense holding L.B. Williams with a big sack to take them out of any type of play that they wanted to run.
So Lawrence Forbes drops back, who is 23, to kick the ball over. Low snap. They get it off. Malik Golson calls for the fair catch, and he makes it at the 25. So a 47-yard punt and no return by Golson.
I would like to see the Hornets either run the ball a little more effectively or get the short passing game going. Corey Murphy's not having a lot of time. You got to do one of two things when you're passing the football. Throw the football out quick or bring some extra people to block.
Well, there's 13 seconds left here in the third quarter, so this more than likely will be the last play before we go into the final frame. They give it off to Malcolm Williams on a reverse. He is hit at the 25. He's going to get up over it, pick up of about 2, and that's going to expire the clock here in the third quarter, where the Morgan State University Bears lead the Delaware State University Hornets 17-13 here at Alumni Stadium in Dover, Delaware.
Remember, this is their last game of the season, a win and a couple of losses, and they're tied first. So this is a big game for the Hornets.
It is huge, mainly after that disastrous start. They ended up coming into playing their home game. They were 1-3. Losses to North Dakota State, Towson State, University of Delaware. They finally won that road game at Savannah State before they came back home.
in
with their home opener against Bethune-Cookman. They lost a heartbreaker there where they were standing toe-to-toe with Bethune-Cookman, just couldn't come up with a victory. Turnovers did them in that week.
For the last 3 or 4 weeks, you can say the Hornets have been playing basically elimination-type football where a loss could end their season, and they've seemed to come away with victories. Last week, they were down 21-3 to Florida A&M and scored 26 unanswered points. This is a very resilient team, and they're going to need a little bit of it if they're down by four entering the fourth quarter.
They do have some character, Derek. As Corey Murphy gets Malik Golson moving from his right to his left, he drops back. He's looking Golson's way, but he's got Milton Williams on a flat route. Over the 50, the 40, the 30, the 25, the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Hornets! Malik Golson with a 72-yard touchdown catch by Corey Murphy right over the middle.
And it was just a great play call. A motion by Malik Golson made the middle of the field very open for Malik Milton Williams to run the slant. You mentioned it earlier that the slant's been there all season long.
Absolutely right, Derek. Every time they've called that slant play, it's been there. Whether they just needed to pick up 5, 10, or a touchdown right there with Milton Williams, but he broke free, and that was all she wrote. 72-yard strike from Corey Murphy to Milton Williams. And now the ever-dreadful extra point attempt. It's up, and it is wide to the left. As the kicking woes continue here, Derek, and the Delaware State University Hornets lead the Morgan State University Bears 19-17.
You kind of think maybe they should just go for it every single time. They just have, it's just so, you know, just so many misses, so many points left on the field where you would think you might as well go for two.
That's 5 points that we've given up here to the Hornets.
Now Morgan State Bears only needs a field goal to get the lead again.
5 points is huge. That's needing a touchdown to make a tie. A 19-17 lead right now, and a field goal wins it puts the Bears ahead. 5 points, 24-17, that's a touchdown lead. Big. Kermit Blunt can't be happy with his special teams today.
Or for the entire season, that matter. They really struggled. They are, one thing they do very well, they are good on onside kicks. We had a game where they faced Howard here, and we saw one of the best onside kicks we've ever seen.
That's true. You couldn't script that one better.
It looks like it might come down to a game like that again. It just has that feel. This is going to be a game that goes down to the wire.
Whoever has the ball last or scores last. Well, Tubbatain Taylor and Orlando Johnson are standing back at their 10, ready to field this one from Mitchell Ward. Going to put the boot into it at the right hash. Wow, what a big touchdown strike there by the Hornets. Ward drives it into the ground again. Taken by an up man. No, it's actually bobbled at the 25. Tubbatain Taylor's got it. Breaks a tackle. Hit at the 35 and down at the 38-yard line. And there they are spotting them yards again there, Derek.
Yeah, that was just, I just don't understand the squib kick. They almost had a chance for a fumble recovery on that one, but they don't get it. And now they're at the 38-yard line, the Bears are. The last time we seen him kick it deep, he kicked it out of the end zone.
Yes.
And especially at this point where they only need a field goal to retake the lead, you just give them very good field position to start. I don't understand it.
Okay, Lamont Brown behind Deontay Holland. Higgins gives it to Brown, and Brown has got running room off the left side, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. Pick up of about 11. That's going to be a first down for the Bears. Ronald Robinson pushed him out of bounds there. Lamont Brown, well over 110 yards rushing the football today. He's been huge for the Bears. They're going to give it to Brown again. Up over the inside the Delaware State 50, down at the 48. Pickup of about 2. 8 from the Delaware State 48-yard line. As Herb Walker Jr. spells Lamont Brown a break, Seth Higgins checks up under center. The true pro set with the wide receiver off to each side. Higgins drops back, he's got pressure. And he shakes it up over the 45 to the 40, inside the 35-yard line. Odell State brought the pressure, but they just couldn't bring him down on that one.
Looked like it was Corey Barnes who had a chance to bring him down, and just a nice move by Higgins. And when you get a chance, you got to bring this guy down. We just see how explosive of a runner he is.
Once he gets into the open field, it's been ugly. So it's first and 10, the Delaware State 36. Deontay Holland, the lone fullback, with a double tight end formation. Seth Higgins in the shotgun formation.
Yeah, Higgins closing in on 100 yards.
And there he goes off the right side. He stumbles at the 35, and he's going to be brought down at the 34. And he just tripped over his own feet.
And I think he's in disbelief because he had a lot of yards in front of him if he just keeps his footing.
Pick up about 2. It's going to be 2nd and 8 from the Delaware State 34. Deontay Holland, the lone back, and he split off slight to the right of Seth Higgins. Higgins checks off. Now he's looking to throw left, and he's got a man. Caught at the 30, inside the 25, and out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. That's Thomas Martin with the reception. Pick up about 12.
And even on that pass, you can tell this is not a passing team. He just kind of flicked it over there, and it took about 3-4 seconds to get to him, it seemed like. Just play a little closer on these receivers. They don't have – Steph Higgins doesn't have the deep threat type of accuracy.
Well, Deontay Holland checks out of the game, and Lamont Brown is back in there as the sole setback.
They're going with a two tight end set here, so expect a run.
Comes Tubbatane Taylor in motion. He's going to set up, float left. They give it to Brown on the left side. He is hit at the line of scrimmage and then hammered at the 18-yard line as Corey Barnes came across and just leveled him.
Not before he was able to get about a good 4-yard gain.
Ball spotted at the 18-yard line of Delaware State. So Morgan State moves it into the red zone. 2nd and 7. Deontay Holland back into the lineup again. And when Holland is out there, Higgins has just been throwing or running.
And even when Holland isn't out there, expect them to run. This is just a running team.
So there goes Holland. And there goes Higgins. On the right side, he's hit again at the line of scrimmage. Breaks free inside the 20 and down to the 15. The Hornets had 3 different hits at him and couldn't bring him down.
Yeah, you can't tackle him like he's a regular quarterback. He's 230 pounds. He bounces off these arm tackles.
So he picks up enough for the first, and now it's going to be 1st and 10 at the 10. Believe it or not, they can still get a first down, just short of the goal line. Deontay Holland is the lone setback. Martin goes in motion. Here comes Higgins again, following Holland along the right side, but he got nothing that time. He's brought down right short of the 10.
Good job.
2nd and 10.
That was a good job by Joe Boyd, forcing that run to the inside. He was trying to bounce it out the entire time. Joe Boyd kept fighting the blocker until he had enough time.
So Deontay Holland checks out of the game, and here comes Lamont Brown. Seth Higgins, 2 wide receivers to the left. Lamont Brown is only setback. He drops back. He's looking to his left. He's throwing. He's got a man in the flat. It's caught, and he's in the end zone for a touchdown. That was Ladarius Spearman, and no one actually picked him up as he crossed the line.
Yeah, nobody's expecting the pass. He just drops back, and Spearman is wide open in the middle of the field.
So Seth Higgins with a 10-yard touchdown strike to Ladarius Spearman. And now Morgan State moves ahead 23-19 with the extra point pending.
They're going with a little trick play here.
And they are. Chris Muller's going to throw it. It's short. Did he catch?
I think he did catch it.
He did catch for the two-point conversion. And Delaware State were just caught flat-footed on that one right there.
Well, that one doesn't hurt them too bad. Either way, it was going to be a touchdown to take the lead. So, but now, if the Del State can't make the extra point, the touchdown just leads to a tied ball game instead of them taking the lead. So I understand why they went for two.
So 25-19 is our score here at Alumni Stadium with 9 minutes and 46 seconds left here in the game.
Last time the Hornets had the ball, the 72-yard strike to Milton Williams with the slant route. Because of the way the Hornets run screen side to side, they're able to expose the middle of the field at times.
Well, the lights have come on here at Alumni Stadium. It's getting dark here.
Once again, this is the last game of the season. Means a lot for both teams. A win for Morgan, and they tie Delaware State for third place in the conference. A win for Delaware State, and they have the possibility to be tied for first place in the MEAC conference.
Chris Muller about ready to put the foot to it. Malik Golson, Milton Williams back at their 10, waiting to receive. Muller gets it off, drives it deep. It's going to be Milton Williams at the 2. He's coming out, hit at the 15. He's dropped at the 17-yard line. As Milton Williams and Malik Golson came together, weren't sure who was going to want to take that ball back.
They're both very good playmakers. They both were thinking, just let me get my hands on a football and I'll make a play. Just didn't work out that time.
Well, Eris Scott normally is back there for kick returns and punt returns, but we saw him in pregame warm-ups. He was out there running around, but we have not seen him for any game-time action today. So Dehan Chung is the lone setback behind Corey Murphy, and this is a huge drive for the Hornets. They trail by 6, and time is running down on them as Chung takes the ball, moves off the left side, and he's going to be short of the 20. So he's going to pick up about 2. It's going to be 2nd and 8.
And that was just a good job by Corey Murphy, bringing in another low snap and still being able to hand the football off.
So 2nd and 8 from the 19. Wide receivers, 2 to the left, 2 to the right. Murphy's got it, dropped back. He's looking right now, left. He's got Malik Golson for a first down at the 29-yard line. Nice catch there by Golson.
And I don't understand why Morgan State only rushed 3 people. They've had since they gotten beat with that blitz, they may try to play a little bit back because a lot of their blitzes are up the middle. But the Hornets' weakness on their offense has been their offensive line.
Well, Chung remains the lone setback. He's going to fake it and give it to Chung, and he's right up the middle, made a nice cut, and just could not break the tackle he needed. Otherwise, he could have been off to the races after a pickup of 3.
Looks like that was Bill Hill with the open field tackle.
Chung had good acceleration up the middle. Picked up 3, and it's going to be 2nd and 7. Ball's marked on the far left hash.
But even on that play, they only rushed 3. They're playing more conservative. And like you like to say, prevent defenses only prevent you from winning. They'll bring 4 this
7.
Time.
He's looking over the middle. Fires low to Malik Golson. Check that.
It's
that
like
was Bo Saravola. Critical 3rd down and 7 for the Hornets. They need to convert. 8 minutes and 4 seconds left here in the game. Want to hang on to this football and put some points on the board.
And you got to at least get your defense some rest. They just got ran through that last possession.
Empty backfield for Murphy as he drops back. He's got time. He's looking down the field. He's got a man.
It's like that's Morris Frazier.
It is Morris Frazier. That's the first time we've called his name today, isn't it?
I think he had one that went over his hands early in the football game. that almost led to an interception. This time, does a good job bringing it in.
He does. Gets his first reception. Gets the first down. That's important. The ball sits at the 42-yard line. Delaware State keeps the drive alive.
And it's good that they're getting some receptions from people named not Golson or Williams.
That is big. Murphy's got time again, and he's got a man. Oh, wow, what a catch.
Like
nice
bobbles.
Yep. Bo Cerevolo.
He's really emerged these last couple of weeks, becoming one of their more favorite targets. They needed somebody to take the pressure off of Golson and Williams, and Cerevolo has definitely done it in the last couple of games. Huge catch, because that could have been intercepted if he doesn't bring that in.
Exactly. Nice 15-yard pickup by Cerevolo. And Murphy's getting some time there to throw his ball. He just needs to realize he's got the time and make the throw. Murphy looking again. Now that one's just batted down into the ground at the 50.
They were trying to set up
Chase Phillips got his arms up and knocked it down.
Had a screen set up for Milton Williams. But I don't think a screen's necessary when they're only rushing three. I'd like to just see them let him step back and just make the right reads. He's having all the time in the world because they're only rushing three people.
So second and 10 from the 43 of the Bears. Delaware State trying to put some points here on the board. Try to regain the lead here late in the game.
They're running the same formation that scored on a slant route.
There it comes, Milton Williams. He's got it at the 40, inside the 35, and down to the 34-yard line. Nice pickup by Milton Williams.
But he's getting a little slow to get up here.
It's going to be a pickup of about 8.
Milton Williams is hurt.
He is a little slow. Officials are calling timeout right now. Milton Williams is up, the one knee.
Looks like his back.
Exactly. He's holding his back. He's on his feet, walking towards the sideline.
And he leads the team in receiving yards. That's a huge loss. That doesn't get much bigger than losing Milton Williams.
Well, the ball sits at the 35-yard line, third and a long one. Definitely a two-down territory for conversion if they need it. Corey Murphy gets the play from the sidelines. Go with Malcolm Williams in the backfield, and Corey Murphy is up under center. They give it to Malcolm Williams, and he's up. He's going to have the first down as he is brought down at the 33-yard line. He got what he needed. Ooh, they are marking him short.
I thought he had it.
I did it as well. It's going to be fourth and less than a yard. Huge conversion right here, Derek.
And the Morgan State fans are making some noise.
They're going to call a timeout. Delaware State's going to want to talk this play over.
A lot of Morgan State fans made it to this game, and it's almost felt like a road game without the band. We've seen a halftime performance by the Morgan State band instead of the Delaware State. We've seen a lot of orange and black in the stands.
The fans definitely travel well. 5 minutes and 58 seconds left here in the game. Delaware State taking their first time out here, and they're faced with a fourth and less than one. Could be the game in the season right here. So what are you going to call, Derek?
Oh, don't put me in that situation. I don't get paid for the money. I don't get paid Kermit Blunt money. But I think he would probably just go with the run here. They're about a half yard short. I really thought he had the first down on the carry on third and two.
Well, he brings Lamar Shaw into the backfield along with Dehun Chung, so he's got some.
Those are the two guys, two running backs for short yardage purposes.
Well, you wonder if any of them can elevate. I just don't like running a sneak during this, and they don't. They give it to Chung. He's going to have the first down. down to the 31-yard line. So he needed one, and he picked up three. So it'll be first and 10 for the Hornets. And they keep the drive moving. First down, Hornets. 25-19, Morgan State leads with 5 minutes and 43 seconds left here in the ball. Delaware State with the football, driving against the Bears. Corey Murphy with Dae-Hun Chung in the backfield. Murphy looking to his left, he's got time. Looking now downfield to the right. Bo Saravolo got pushed out of bounds. So that would have been a penalty even if he makes the catch.
Also, Milton Williams is back in the game.
This will be second and 10. Corey Murphy's definitely getting some time here on this drive to make his passes.
Yeah, Morgan State seems concerned with the big play. They've blitzed a couple times. They've gotten there, but also have given up some passes down the middle of the field for touchdowns.
So Dae-Hun Chung is the lone setback. Murphy drops back. He's looking to his left. He's got a man, Milton Williams. He's got a ball caught and out of bounds at the 9-yard line. What a great catch by Milton Williams.
And he abuses one-on-one coverage.
Pick up a 22 on that one.
And the safety was slow to get there to help out his corner. Nice throw by Corey Murphy, putting it on the sidelines to protect this receiver.
And Milton looks pretty healthy on that catch right there. Pick up a 22, first and goal at the 9. Ball spotted at the left hash. So the Hornets are in the red zone trying to put the tie on and hopefully
make
convert.
The extra point.
So Murphy drops back. He's got time. He's throwing the slant again. And Milton Williams didn't even have his head turned around. The ball was already in the air. Second and goal from the 9.
That was not a good decision by Corey Murphy. The only good part was the ball was so slow, nobody could pick it up.
Now, Murphy's got more time than he really thinks he does.
Mm-hmm.
He had
only
time to
three.
Sit back there and make a choice. He didn't have to go to Milton Williams. He could have waited for somebody else to break open. 5 receivers set, 3 to the right, 2 to the left. Murphy pointing towards that right side, trying to get Malik Golson online. He's looking, he's throwing deep, and he's got a man. It's Malcolm Williams for a touchdown. Hornets!
I didn't even see Malcolm Williams.
Malcolm Williams.
What did he throw that football to? And Malcolm Williams just sneaked to the corner of the end zone and made a great catch. It's a guy who was out for about 4 games with a turf toe, was very upset about it. Made the biggest catch of the season for the Hornets. Now
Milton,
will be the dreaded extra kick.
Milton Williams ran the slant route. And when he did that, it opened up that far corner, and Malcolm Williams just ran right behind him, and no one was even on him. So we're tied here, 25-25, with Mitchell Ward trying to get the lead for the Hornets. Ball is down, kick is up, and it is good. And the Delaware State University Hornets now lead the Morgan State University Bears 26-25 with 4 minutes and 49 seconds left in the ball game.
Morgan State doesn't have to panic and can still run their offense the way that they want to do. So I will be very surprised to see them coming out and passing here in a situation where they only need a field goal to win. But we haven't seen their field goal kicking unit neither. We don't know how good they are. They've gone for it a lot on 4th and 1 and 4th and 2. So I don't think they have too much confidence in their kicker.
Well, they did get the one field goal in the first half.
I think they were ahead by
10-6.
That was like at the 10 or something. They were very close, I think, when he made that field goal. It was a 39-yarder, so they would have to get probably about the 26, 27-yard line. I'm not good at math. I'm just guessing.
It was at 29, so 39-yard field goal.
So you see how it was close, though?
Yeah.
Probably it was at 1 or 2 yards.
Yeah, what's that? What's that amongst friends, right? So let's set the table for you. 26-25 Hornets, 4 minutes and 49 seconds left here in the game. Delaware State with 2 timeouts left and Morgan State with 1. But the biggest problem is that Delaware State has only been able to put Higgins on the ground once.
And they're going to have to kick it deep. They're prepared for the squib kick.
They can't let them start off at midfield with the football. Tubbetane Taylor is in the back to receive it along with Orlando Johnson. They kick it off towards Johnson. He's going to let it bounce, and now it's going to go out of bounds. So that causes it to be able to be spotted at the 35. So we can't win for losing with this kicking game.
When he had to kick it deep, they had the squib kick unit out. They were ready for a squib return. And that's just unfortunate. But it's still better than the 41-yard line. I guess, you know, half glass full, right?
Pick your poison.
See, that's not half glass full talking.
Depends on whether you have any arsenic in there. Well, the Hornet defense needs to come up big. Take that back, they're going to have a re-kick. Wow, I didn't expect that.
They do have two special teams returns. And a lot of times with penalties like these, your defense is tired. Your return defense is tired from running all the way down the field. So a lot of mistakes can happen.
Okay, Mitchell Ward. You're going to have to drive it deep. Get the good coverage.
I would not be opposed to calling a timeout here if I'm the Hornets. It gives these guys a little bit more rest before they have to run 80 yards down the field.
Well, they do have two punt or kickoff teams, so they could bring in a kickoff team two in to take care of that if they would. Mitchell Ward approaches, and now he drives it right into the ground. Takes a high bounce, it's fielded short. Hit at the 40, he's up over the 40, and that is Herb Walker Jr., one of the upmen that picked it up, and Morgan State will start first at 10 at their 42-yard line.
And I know we've been talking about the squib kicks. In a situation like that, I don't really mind it because your team just ran 80 yards down the field. A squib kick gives them a little bit more time to get down there. And there's only a 5-yard difference from the 35 to the 40.
That was Troy Cornwall with the tackle there. Seth Higgins drops back in the shotgun. He's got Lamont Brown in the backfield with him. He's going to give it to Brown, who's off the right side. He's hit at the 44-yard line, up over the 45, so a pickup of about two. It's going to bring up a second and eight.
Another good tackle by Tarek Colston on the edge. These secondaries, they can get up and stop the run, especially on the edges.
So Higgins again in the shotgun with Brown in the backfield. Three wide receivers to the left. Now they all start to turn in towards the sideline to get the play. Higgins dropped back. He's got time. Looking off to his right, he's got a man over the middle and is caught at the 36-yard line. As Grayling Harrison made a nice catch off his back shoulder and hauls it in for a first down.
They're about 6 yards, maybe a little bit more from field goal range. This is the part where you kind of milk the time now and get your running game back in and try to win with a field goal.
And a motion to the right. Higgins drops back. Now he's going to run right up the middle. He's got room. Hit at the 34-yard line. His head snapped back pretty good on that one.
He bounces right up, though.
Pick up of about four. It's going to be second and six from the 33-yard line. Lamont Brown, again, is a lone setback. 3 minutes and 10 seconds left here in their ball game, with Delaware State leading 26-25. Here comes Higgins around to the left side. He's hitting the backfield up over or inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line.
Making about third and two.
Yes, he's going to be short of the first down, so about third and two.
It's been a lot of third and twos for the Bears.
But they are definitely inside field goal range at this time. Now the big back, Deontay Holland, checks in. we can more than likely expect to see Higgins run right.
Probably some type of quarterback sweep. The Hornets loading a box.
And there he goes, right up the middle. He's over the 25, inside the 20, inside the 15, and down to the 12-yard line.
And Joe Boyd came free, but he just ran past Higgins. He just didn't have the right pursuit angle, or Higgins would have been down for a loss. Unfortunate, they read the play perfect, but just did not execute it.
So Seth Higgins brings it down to the 14-yard line, where it'll be first 10 and the 14 with 2 minutes and 5 seconds left in the game, and the clock is running.
And now the Hornets need to think about calling a timeout themselves to save some time, just in case the Bears score.
There goes Higgins to run right up the middle again. He's hit at the 15, still on his feet. He's going to be brought down to about the 13. The Hornets are saying they have the football. Let's see. There isn't any call yet. We'll see. Still waiting on official word. They're saying second down, so
I think forward progress might have stopped.
May have. Bears retain possession.
And the time keeps ticking.
Be second and 10 from the 13. Check that. They're inside the 10.
Time is
second
ticking.
And 5 from the 8. He picked up 5 on that one. Higgins gives it off to Lamont Brown. He scampers inside the 5, and he is down to the 4-yard line.
The opponent's going to have to call a timeout.
We do have a stoppage in play right now. So it'll be 3rd and 1 at the 4 with 51 seconds left.
This is the biggest third down of the game. If Morgan State converts this, they could just run the time down and kick the field goal for the win. Delaware State gets the stop. They'll get the ball back with about 40, 45 seconds left.
It's huge. Overall, they just haven't had an answer for Seth Higgins this afternoon. He's been able to run. He's been able to step back and throw. Granted, his passing game is not a strong point, but they've brought him to the turf one time today. That's been it.
If you're the Hornets, do you just let these guys score? A field goal, you know, in theory, they kick a field goal, and then we march down and kick a field goal. It seems like it works, but the special teams for the Hornets haven't been good anyway.
That is true. We'll see what Seth Higgins does here on this 3rd and 1. He gives, fakes it, and he's going to walk into the end zone for a touchdown. And Seth Higgins scores with 46 seconds left. So now the Morgan State Bears lead 31-26 over the Delaware State Hornets.
And Seth Higgins is hurt. He took a shot at the end of that, and he is in a lot of pain.
He has not gotten up. He's still writhing in the end zone. He took a shot.
I don't know if it's his midsection or if he's holding his arm. It looks like it's his arm. His right arm.
He's got his hand.
Wrist.
Could be his wrist, yes. Well, Chris Muller gets on to attempt the extra point. So make it a 6-point lead if he converts. Kick is low. They have to fake. They've got him. So they drop him back down at the 16-yard line.
And that's huge. now they just score and don't have to worry about the extra point.
Lawrence Forbes just had trouble taking the snap, putting it down. Moeller never even got a kick away. Scrambling, trying to look for somebody open in the end zone. There was nobody there. So, down to 46 seconds left. Delaware State has one timeout left, and they trail 31-26. They have some time, but they're going to have to get the ball into the end zone. All we can hope for is Morgan State goes into their prevent defense.
And the Hornets do still have a timeout. We saw earlier in the end of the first half, Corey Murphy marched his team close to the end zone, but the field goal got blocked. This is his last game, senior day. This is the moment you dream of as a kid. So had a chance to be first in the MEAC.
Yeah,
he's probably dreamed of this situation of at least a handful of times since he's been here. So,
yeah, the seniors don't want to leave Alumni Stadium on a sour note. Moeller kicks it out of the back of the end zone, so Delaware State will get a first and 10 at their own 25. So Corey Murphy's going to have to march him 75 yards down the field to win this football game with 46 seconds left in the game and one timeout. They can still run those slant routes, but they're not going to be able to. You got to make sure you get substantial gains. You want to be able to move the chains to where the clock is stopping. 2 or 3 yard pickups in the field is not going to get the job done.
One good thing about the slant routes is Morgan State is going to be covering those sidelines.
There goes Murphy over the middle and is knocked down at the line of scrimmage as DeMarco Bisbee got his big paws up there and slapped it down at the 25. Second and 10. Four seconds off the clock, so we're down to 42 seconds here left in the game. Corey Murphy goes with three wide receivers to the right and two with the left. Murphy drops back. He's got time. He's looking off to his right, and he throws it right into the hands Bill Hill, and he just plain out dropped it. I guess that's why he's a linebacker, not a wide receiver.
He's looking around like, hey, man, I'm just supposed to tackle people, okay? Don't look at me.
Third and 10 from the 25.
But we got the Morgan State coordinators on the other side, and all of them just went, oh, man, come on.
38 seconds left here in the ball game. Season of Delaware State University. Hornet football is winding down here at Alumni Stadium. Corey Murphy drops back. He's got some time. Throwing an out route to Bo Saravolo. And what a nice catch at the 36-yard line by Bo.
And he's having a great game. And that was a beautiful pass. That was not he was not open.
Check that. That was Morris Frazier with a second catch, not Bo Saravolo. Very nice catch. They convert, move the chains, and it's first and 10 from the 36-yard line.
Lee Gosley has a linebacker in coverage.
Murphy's going to get hit. He's going to throw it long. Falls incomplete out of bounds as he definitely got the pressure from Chase Phillips. He laid the wood to him. Second and 10 from the 36. 28 seconds left. They really need to get down the field. They're running low on time to get this game. Three wide receivers to the left, two to the right. Corey Murphy drops back. He's got time. He's got Milton Williams. He's going to step out of bounds at around the 45-yard line.
They're going to have to get a little bit more yards.
Mark him at the 44.
24 seconds left. You need to get a huge chunk of coming up here.
Third and two. And clock is the issue.
They do have one timeout, so they can use the middle of the field once. They can't do it twice. They can go there once. You might want to maybe a deep post.
Murphy drops back. He's got time. He's got Milt Williams with a catch. That's going to stop the clock as they move the chains. They may want to spike that ball is to get the ball inside the 44.
But they're not looking to spike.
Clock is moving at 17 seconds left. Corey Murphy drops back. He's looking to his left. He's throwing to his left. He throws it over the head of Bo Cerevolo. And we have 10 seconds left in this ball game.
I think you need to call a timeout on that possession. They have a timeout remaining.
So that means they got one more play.
You might be able to get a quick one, maybe get it closer for a Hail Mary type of throw. We see a lot in college football where you do convert in these type of plays.
Yeah, they don't need to go for the end zone on this one, but definitely they won't have enough time to.
Just about everybody in Alumni Stadium is standing up.
So Murphy's looking. He's looking, still looking. Now he's throwing long. He's got Milt Williams out there, but he's going to fire it over his hands. So we have 3 seconds left. So the ball game is going to come down to this final play. It's going to be 3rd and 10 at the 44. And the Delaware State University Hornets season rests on this 3rd and 44 with 3 seconds left, trailing Morgan State 31-26. Well, Murphy drops back. He's got time. Dances around a little bit. Still has time. He's still looking. Looking to throw, and now he's going to get hit. Breaks free at the 50.
He's going to have to
throw it. He's got time. He's throwing it into the end zone, and it's knocked away. Wow, Murphy just stayed on his feet, trying to scramble as much as possible, but he just couldn't get it done. And the Morgan State University Bears had defeated the Delaware State University Hornets 31-26 here at Alumni Stadium in Dover, Delaware.
That's a heartbreaking loss, but this is a young Hornets team like we talked about in the past. They have a great future for next season. It's unfortunate for Corey Murphy that his last game ends in a loss.
What a tough loss it is to finish up, but what a good season overall for this young football team.
They're going to have to address their special teams. Kickoffs, punt returns, everything needs to be addressed on that special teams line.
Well,
left
ladies,
a lot of points on the field today.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for joining us today here at WDSU Television. Before we sign off today, I'd like to take some time to acknowledge some people that helped make this thing happen each and every Saturday that we're home. Our color announcer is Derek Slayton. He was with me this afternoon here in the booth. Our sideline reporter, and also up on top of the press box is Byron Dixon. Our press box cameras are Azure Rucker and Mike Patterson. Our line cameras are Keith Travick and Portland Davis. Our line assists were Daniel Benio and Harry Hudson. Our graphics is Taden Tomko. And our director is Antonio Jones. Our producer is Mr. Vincent Celli. And our executive producers, Kamal Atkins and Ebony Ramsey. WDSU Television and Delaware State University football Hornets games are produced by the students and staff of the Department of Mass Communications of Delaware State University in Dover, Delaware. You can connect to us on WDSU Television. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. And you can see us on our webpage at www.desu.edu. Again, thanks, everybody. And don't forget, we'll be back on Monday as we shift from the gridiron to the hard court floors as basketball kicks off with our first game against the University of Delaware at 7 o'clock. We'll begin our live streaming at 6:30. Stay tuned as we'll have a wrap-up here in a couple of minutes from upstairs. And I'm Roland DeVries. Thank you.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser.
Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here's going to help you, because no one
teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit Stop.
I come from a big family. I'm the oldest of six. To me, being the first person to go to college, it's like setting a standard, you know? My little brother is 8 years old now. I challenge his curiosity. I challenge him to dream. I have to paint a picture for him that he can look up to and live up to and possibly be better than. My name is Jacquez, and I am your dividend.
Those dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community with experts and other caregivers to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
Welcome to the post-game wrap-up show. The Delaware State University Hornets suffered a tough loss to Morgan State, 31-26. I'm joined by the voices of Delaware State football, Roland DeVries and Derek Slate. And guys, what did you take away from this loss today?
This is a team that's going to have a very bright future. Unfortunately, this was Corey Murphy's last game, and you wanted to see him go out with a win. But they have a lot of talent. Malik Gostin on the outside, Malcolm Williams, the running back Malcolm Williams, Milton Williams, the receiver. A lot of people in the secondary will still be there. A lot of people on the defensive front. They have a bright future.
How about you, Roland?
I'm looking forward to seeing this young offensive line. I mean, they had a great season this year. When you're talking about freshmen and sophomores really stepping it up and making Corey Murphy feel comfortable back there, it was good to see them perform quite nicely this season.
With that being said, there are 6 home games next season for this team, so hopefully they can build on this momentum and look for a chance to win in MEAC. With that being said, don't forget to check us out on our basketball coverage this upcoming Monday as the University of Delaware visits the Delaware State University Men's Basketball Hornets. And you can check us out at www.desu.edu and scroll down to the YouTube icon. With that being said, thank you for watching and have a great night.